Welcome to One Friday Fights, live from the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Hello, I'm Achilles Rally, and I'm joined with the former Muay Thai and kickboxing champion, Brian McGrath. One Friday Fights is a global platform in search of global superstars.
Achilles, these fighters have the opportunity to secure that $100,000 contract and make their way into the world's largest martial arts organization, ONE Championship.
Oh, and do we have a card stacked with absolute bangers tonight, headlined by this catchweight 140-pound Muay Thai fight as Panrit takes on Alexey Balyko.
Both these fighters collected finishes and bonuses in their last outings. First up, we have the fighter from Russia, Alexey Balyko. He has a devastating, beautiful hybrid style that mixes boxing, kickboxing, and Muay Thai. He is currently on a two-fight win streak, and he would love nothing more than to pick up another big knockout tonight and make it 3-0, as well as scoring that big bonus. But he is going to have to get through the always tough and very elite fighter from Thailand, Panrit. In his last bout, he looked very impressive against Gonglai, where he scored a third round TKO. He demonstrated patience and accuracy, as well as a diverse striking skill set. He knows another big knockout tonight will put him one step closer to securing that $100,000 contract and changing his life.
Nothing but fire in that main event. But before that, at 132-pound Muay Thai, the highly anticipated debut of Chalongsuk as he takes on the super dangerous Donking. But before that, we have six fan favorite bouts coming your way. Tran Quoc Tuan, the time bomb from Vietnam, takes on Yuya Jonishi, the karate specialist from Japan. But in bantamweight Muay Thai, the feature bout of the night, the sensational Fabio Reis takes on the Lithuanian legend, Soe Lin Oo.
That's right, the man of steel from Myanmar, Soe Lin Oo. He is a legend in his home country under that Lithuanian rule set. He won his debut in the little gloves against a very tough Masayoshi Tsuhashi with a third round TKO and picked up a bonus. He's gonna have to take on the sensational Fabio Reis from Portugal. Reis has two huge knockout victories over very elite Thais, Sangmini and Ferrari, with monster left hooks.
Guaranteed absolute banger. But to kick things off, the first bout of the night, catchweight 163-pound mixed martial arts, Kojincha Komodinova takes on Akari Ogata. Ogata is 9 years older, 1 inch taller, and has a slight weight disadvantage. This one is Uzbekistan taking on Japan. Global rules mixed martial arts, that's 3 5-minute rounds. The bout will be judged as a whole. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. No spiking or throws on the head, neck, or spine. Let's kick things off on One Friday Fights.
From the blue corner, Akari Ogata!
Akari Ogata from Kumamoto, Japan, opening up the fights here on One Friday Fights. Coming in hot from the AACC gym, highly decorated judoka. Bronze at the Asia Championships, silver at the Worlds. This is a grappler at heart, but with the experience that she has collected in the shooto scene, she is ripe and ready for her debut here on One Friday Fights.
Achilles, I have to give a quick shout out. She is from Kumamoto, Japan, which is a sister city to my hometown, Missoula, Montana, a beautiful location in Japan. She has that high-level judo skill set, incredibly high level. She told us she wants to clinch, get in close, get that throw. And then from there, ground and pound for submission. It's not a complicated game plan, but she is oh so good at it. We asked her about her striking. She has a karate background, she told you. So she's got that karate-based striking background which she can add and mix into her combinations.
Kari Ogata makes her way into the one Lumpinee ring.
From the red corner, Hojinsa Komadinova!
If you thought one decorated judoka wasn't enough, Komadinova is coming in just as decorated as her opponent, Ogata. From the beautiful capital city, Tashkent in Uzbekistan, she is on a 67% win rate. This young lady has dedicated her life to MMA, so much so that her husband is also an MMA fighter, Jablonbek Topabayev. And this combination, the two, they live their life by a code, a martial arts code. And that code, we get to see here tonight, Ryan.
Stylistically, this matchup is so interesting. Two extremely high-level judoka, and then you have to add in Hojinsa's sambo ability as well. When we spoke to her, she knows that her opponent has a very formidable judo game, but she thinks that hers is better. She also said, I think my opponent has a weak upper body, and I don't think she is going to be able to withstand my heavy punches, especially those overhands that she loves to throw. Speaking with her was so interesting because you could just feel her passion for the sport and for fighting, and it really came through. I think she's going to bring so much dynamic energy into this bout and have a really fast start, Achilles.
From Oldenova, the strong judo and sambo background, might have to give her the edge in the striking here. Sambo is known to have two disciplines in the combat sambo as well. So be sure for Komadinova to be ready for this fight.
Welcome to One Friday Fights, live from the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. We begin with 3 5-minute rounds of a 163-pound MMA contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of AACC, representing Japan, Akari Ogata! And introducing her opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Rakabat Club, representing Uzbekistan, Hojinsa, Uzbek Tigress, Komadinova!
Listen, stand here, please. You both understand the rules. Face me. Keep it clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all time. Touch glove if you want, then go back to your corners. Touch glove, back to your corners first, please.
Referee Suleiman, the guardian in the ring for this
back up.
Judge,
MMA matchup. Judge, time. You ready? You ready? Let's go!
One Friday Fights is the global platform in search of the next global superstar. Akari Ogata and Komadinova both make their debuts here. Can't help but think, Brian, that such decorated grapplers, they might end up spending a lot of time striking on the feet.
We will get to that point, no doubt, but they are trading blows at this point. The heavy shots from Komadinova are landing on Ogata. She needs to get on her bicycle and circle out, get out of that corner. Wow! And Komadinova goes down as well.
Maybe took a bit of a slip there. Lucky to give Ogata some breathing time because she was getting smothered with punches. from Komodanova from Uzbekistan. And she starts the first round very strong.
Ogata was looking very good with the lead hand and the lead low kick. But Komodanova was using that power and driving forward with the overhand rights very successfully there in that exchange.
Just as we said, Brian, that the grappling might cancel each other out. Such highly decorated judokas, both of these ladies, they just decided to trade, because I tell you this, for either of these two to hit a takedown on each other, it will take up a lot of energy. So these ladies need to conserve that as best as they can if they're going to look for a finish.
You are 100% correct here, Achilles. Both being pretty effective with the jab. Komodanova has landed a few good ones, but so has Ogata. I think the X factor is the power that Komodanova throws with those big hooking shots that come over the top. And here is a takedown, finally.
That was a nice switch of levels for Komodanova, hitting the Morotegari double leg takedown, ending up in the close guard of Ogata. So this is a position where Ogata is going to need to open her guard if she wants to improve and get off her back here. Because this is not where she wants to be if Komodanova starts to land ground and pound.
Please, how would a judo player use their guard successfully to get out of this position and get back up and get to the standing position?
She's definitely going to need to open her guard, Brian. And that being said, she's going to need to get one of her shins in front of the middle part of Komodanova's body if she's going to even attempt to try and get a technical stand-up and stand up in some way, because Komodanova right now is very cleverly using her left hand to pin Ogata down in the close guard while she lands strikes with whatever she can land with her right hand, whether that be the fist, the forearm, or the elbow. But very good work from Komodanova.
When we spoke to Komodanova, she spoke with such passion, and especially about how she just thought that she was stronger and more aggressive. And you can see how powerful she is from this position. These elbows over the top, I mean, how many of those do you think Ogata can take before they really start to add up?
Yeah, these are peppering shots.
Let go of the t-shirt. Hey, let go.
Not where Ogata wants to be. As the guard opens now, this is the chance for the shift in momentum. As you see, she tries to push off to create some space so she could possibly stand up. But Komodanova is all over her like a hawk.
There is that big clubbing overhand right again, right? As Ogata goes to stand up. This is a bad position for Ogata here. Komodanova has her in the corner, and now they're moving into that clinch position where they're both going to be so good and so strong.
Yeah, Ogata did well to get back to her feet, but that's not the kind of technique that is efficient for MMA, turning it back like that. With the judo techniques, the haragoshi without the proper overhook control can lead to this kind of dangerous position that we're seeing. Ogata threatening to get on the back of Komodanova, but good defense so far from the Uzbek fighter.
Ogata spoke about how much training she had to do to adapt her judo game from the dogi to this no-gi MMA situation. She said she loves the underhook position. She loves to get on the back and drape the arm as well. And she's in one of those positions just as we speak right now, looking like she's maintaining a lot of control.
You're right there, Brian. That is exactly the type of gripping that she told us she was going to utilize in this fight. And coming right at the right moment after taking heavy shots from Komodanova in the first round. We're entering the final 10 seconds, and somehow Ogata has weathered the early storm.
Yeah, the power advantage for Komodanova is, you know, plain to see in the exchanges. Ogata is going to have to figure it out, make some adaptations here in the second round.
Yeah, Brian, that was not a good round for Ogata. She's going to need to rethink her strategy in the corner. As Komodanova, in my opinion, Brian, took that first round.
Yes, very strong first round. Here is one of those looping overhand rights, then to the elbow on the ground. You can see the power and the tenacity from Komodanova here. This time a jab, both of them exchanging jabs at points in the fight, but Colmo De Nova really landing effectively and following up effectively. You can see that Barashier landing the jab, following even when they exchange, she still stays in the pocket and throws.
Hey, Blue, hey, let me see your mouth guard. Stay there. See your mouth guard.
Ladies.
Okay.
The 163-pound catchweight Muay Thai.
Let's go!
Double debutantes. It's only the best of the best in the world are invited to ONE Championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. And Ogata and Colmo De Nova get to scrapping right away in the second round. But the fight is judged in its entirety. But the round was a good opportunity for these ladies to rethink their strategy as Ogata tries to pursue the takedown there, but Colmo De Nova doing well to stay safe for now.
Yeah, Ogata did a good job there of shutting down the initial takedown attempt from Colmo De Nova, and it looks like they're back at this striking position and they're gonna be trading blows again. Nice right hand from Ogata. Another one lands, a nice shot. Ogata's pressing forward.
Yeah, Ryan, this is good work from Ogata, showing that she's not discouraged from taking the early damage in the first round, coming out strong in the second. She has the overhook here, but again, if Colmo De Nova was not such an experienced judoka, she would have gotten tossed already as these two ladies trade in the pocket with ferocious strikes.
Just trading shots in the pocket, exactly right, Achilles. Ogata seems to have found her range a little better, feels more confident with her punches, and is just happy to duke it out with Colmo De Nova. Now they are in the corner in the clinch position and trading knees.
This may be the change in momentum that Ogata was looking for. Taking early damage in the first round. Can she get the hip toss here? Unsuccessful Haragoshi as she changes back to the strikes, and that is why training all the disciplines is so important. This is mixed martial arts. You need to be well-versed, not just in the takedowns, but in the striking, in the submission areas, in the wrestling. And that's a nice sprawl defense there. Again, going for the overhook control is Ogata.
The thing about all of these exchanges in the standing position are they are so taxing. They really require you to have a pretty sizable gas tank. So this fight is gonna start to move into that deep water, and we're gonna see who has done the conditioning, who has the better cardio and stamina, and really that will allow someone to break away a little bit here. Who is the more conditioned fighter?
Nice knees to the midsection of Colmo De Nova. Ogata starting to get the rhythm now, and again, another knee flush to the belly. She pressures Colmo De Nova in the corner. Not much effort yet from Colmo De Nova to try and reverse this position. This is not a good position for her to have her back on the ropes like this.
Ogata looks so strong in this position, and all of these knees to the midsection of Colmo De Nova are money in the bank, especially against an opponent who is starting to feel fatigued. You will see when the knees start to land and build up that it will make Colmo De Nova's posture drop and bend even more, and that will be a great position for Ogata to be in for a throw or possibly even a knee to the head.
That is the grip that Ogata told us that she wanted to utilize. Clinching the hands, it's almost like a Muay Thai clinch. Over under, the tight head control, the nice Niyashi Barai foot sweep with the takedown ending up on top. It's gonna be interesting if she can improve her position here, but the willpower to get up from Colmo De Nova is exceptional right now as she is taking immense pressure from Ogata.
Colmo De Nova is hunting for that single leg, but giving it up now. Ogata has a big, strong position on her back. From here, she can let those knees rain even more. Not a good position at all for Colmo De Nova.
The shift in momentum is evident in the second round.
Let's go, finish.
The pressure from Ogata starting to take a toll on her Uzbek opponent, Colmo De Nova. She again pushes her into the corner. And he's peppering her with knee strikes to the body. And a nice Osotogari, major alto reaping to temporarily trip her opponent down. And the energy, Brian, to get up from a takedown like that from Komolda Nova is a lot.
Ogata is just doing a great job of keeping her weight and pressure on Komolda Nova and reining the pain with those knees. She spoke to us about loving this position, but she didn't tell us how good she was with the knee attacks. It's just like the Muay Thai clinch, but a bit of a variation, right, Achilles?
Oh, absolutely. Okari Ogata going back to her bread and butter. Clinch work. Tight on the ropes, shoulder pressure, heavy shoulder pressure. Take a look at this replay.
More exchanging from these fighters early on, but the story of that round, Ogata with the pressure in the corner, clinching up, controlling the arms, and throwing knee after knee, multiple knees. Ogata seemed to feel more confident in her strikes this round. They were trading, but Ogata pushed forward and got to that clinching position that she talked about liking so much.
Are you okay to continue? Are you okay? Are you okay? Final round. Let's go.
Third and final round. This is the world's largest martial arts platform, and winning convincingly gives them the greatest opportunity, but they have to show dominance. They have to show the hunger that they want to win and that they want to eventually be a champion, because only the best of the best fighters from around the world come to compete here at one championship. And just as they left off the second round, Ogata is back in control. One Friday fights debut for both of these ladies. As Ogata gets her hooks in and is working from the back control position.
Ogata just looking so comfortable coming out, very confident in the third round, using the strikes. Komolda Nova with a shoot in early, but Ogata stuffing that takedown attempt. And like you just said, Achilles, now she is on the back with the hooks in, just stretching her opponent out and letting the punches come from the side.
Oh, bro, this is the worst position that you could be in for any kind of MMA or grappling match. Belly down, flat on the belly, unable to defend. The referee has seen enough as Ogata rains down the ground and pound. And after weathering the early storm in round one, takes the victory from the hands of Komolda Nova and gets her debut finish.
Ogata took a little bit of time in that first round to get comfortable. The power from Komolda Nova was vast. She was very strong. But we saw in the second a bit of a shift from Ogata. She was more comfortable with the strikes, and then she found that position that she was very comfortable in, the clinch, and she could let the knees go and really control. And then it was all her from that third round on. Here we see she's got the back. She's letting the punches go. At this point, Komolda Nova is not able to intelligently protect and defend herself. So the referee jumps in. Ogata's pressure just proving to be too much. The blows raining down to the sides of Komolda Nova's head. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 16 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Akari Ogata!
Akari Ogata from Japan with a successful debut, showcasing her judo skills to get the job done in this mixed martial arts bout. There you see, the back control was just too much for Komolda Nova to take. As soon as Ogata sinked her hooks in the back, it was game over. All she needed to do was stay there and just rain down on the ground and pound. But coming up after the break, we have an absolute banger of an MMA match. as Gritsanenko takes on Matsuda.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
Being at the top of your game is a lonely pursuit. For over a decade, my team and I have built the one brand into a billion-dollar sports media empire. Throughout my life, I've been a warrior in the ring and in the boardroom. Now, I need a champion who can conquer fears, doubts, and insecurities and go to the next level. Across two of the world's most advanced and modern countries, Singapore and Qatar.
Go, my kids!
10 candidates must prove their mettle in a fear-ignited gauntlet of physical tasks and business challenges.
We want to keep that curiosity.
It's not like customers would realize.
I don't buy food. It's a definite no-go.
In this cutthroat world where
like
business is a constant war.
Dare to insult me like this. That's it. I don't give a
there can be.
I hate bullies and I hate liars.
Only one winner.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
I need rising superstars who can break new ground and make history. Ready to fight and hungry to win at my side. All fighting for one dream. A $250,000 job offer and the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to work directly with me. Welcome to the world's toughest edition of The Apprentice.
One Friday Fight continuing to change the landscape of martial arts.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights here at the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Coming up next, we have catchweight 163 pounds mixed martial arts as Mikhail Gritsanenko takes on Seiya Matsuda. They are equal in age as Matsuda is 3 inches shorter but has a slight weight advantage. This one is Russia taking on Japan. We're going global rules mixed martial arts. That's 3 5-minute rounds. The bout will be judged as a whole. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. No spiking or throws on the head, neck, or spine.
From the blue corner, Seiya Matsuda!
Seiya Matsuda, undefeated so far as a mixed martial artist. Heavy judoka from back in the day. Former policeman, used to train out of the Keistro Dojo. I trained there myself, Brian, and I can tell you something about that place. That place is the most hardcore place in the world to practice judo. They make you sign a consent form that you won't hold them responsible if they injure you. But that's just to show you that the people coming out of that gym just training are coming out in stretchers. So for someone like Matsuda to make it out of a system like that, you can be sure that this man is tough.
Achilles, I have only sat on the sidelines and watched judo training in Japan, but I've seen it with my own eyes, and it is absolutely insane. You are not wrong. This fighter, however, he has the great judo background, but he's not just a judo fighter. He trains wrestling. He's from Blue Dog Gym, which also has two very famous Thai trainers from Thailand. So he's got the mitts, he's got to work on the striking, the elbows and the knees. So he's coming in with a very mixed skill set, but he knows what his strength is, and it is his judo background, and he really wants to make use of it.
Suda enters the one Lumpinee ring.
From the red corner, Mikhail Gritsanenko!
Russian hitman, Mikhail Pritsanenko, coming in hot, fighting out of the Soma Fight Club. 80% win rate. Started training at the age of six. 6 years ago, my bad, sorry. Also served in the army. That is why he had a long, extensive military background. It was only till 6 years ago that he found martial arts and decided to continue on that journey. And it's from the hand-to-hand combat that he has through the military that you will see this aggression in this man.
A very extensive amateur background, over 40 fights in kickboxing and over 30 fights in amateur MMA. So a ton of experience for this fighter here. He is very aggressive, but he's very honest. His background is that striking. He loves to strike. When he was appraising his opponent, he said, I know that my opponent is aggressive, but I see tons of holes and I don't see very much head movement. So of course, I am going to headhunt and look to put my hands on that dome piece of my opponent if I get a chance.
Now, this match is 3 5-minute rounds of a 163-pound MMA contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Blue Dog Gym, representing Japan, Seiya Matsuda! And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Soma Fight Club, holding an MMA record of 4-1, representing Russia, Mikhail Russian Hitman, Pritsanenko!
Blue here, red here. You both understand the rules, yes. Okay? Let's keep this clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all time. Touch glove if you want, and go back to your corner. Touch glove, back to your corners. Judge.
This is
judge
the place
time.
For dreams to
you ready?
Come true. And to
you
get
ready? Let's go!
$100,000 invitation to the big leagues. Suda versus Pritsanenko. Suda just full of power. He takes early pressure from Pritsanenko and some clean strikes landed as Matsuda is forced to enter the grappling there.
Great game plan from Pritsanenko to come out with a few blistering shots, really threw Matsuda off there. It's a great way to get respect early as well.
Big shots landed in the beginning there for Pritsanenko, forcing Matsuda to take a step back. Oh, a nice level change there, but nicely defended from Pritsanenko. These two, ooh, swing and a miss there, the duck under the elbow from Matsuda.
Pritsanenko handling these tight clinched positions very well, pushing the arm off and going for the elbow too. He's got some game, he's got something to offer in these tight positions as well, Achilles.
Tight striking there from Pritsanenko. Able to land. Again, we talked about the toughness of Matsuda as he took a 1-2 combination. Tries to counter with a double leg, forcing Pritsanenko on the ropes. But that was pinpoint accuracy in the combinations there, Brian.
Ooh, very clean from Pritsanenko. That left hook into the right straight, mixing some low kicks. He really is a well-schooled striker. There, stepping back, the checked left hook. Matsuda has to be very careful not to get wild when he steps in. This is what Pritsanenko had talked about, that Matsuda can get a little bit wild.
Locked and loaded. Pritsanenko tries to read his Japanese opponent. Told us that he wants to go for the finish. He wants to get the knockout. Matsuda is the kind of dance partner. It's not going to be easy to get the steps that you want. See already he's taking big shots. They might accumulate, but he will for sure show his Bushido warrior spirit. That is for sure.
Pritsanenko displaying great footwork right off the bat here. Matsuda leaping in with a jab earlier. Pritsanenko stepping back up and then the right hand over the top. Just very well schooled. Very clean. Ooh! And the shin landing right on Matsuda's chin as he goes in for the takedown.
Matsuda is taking some shots and another from Vitalenko. Matsuda with the poker face. His head looking like a pinball in a machine right now. Every time Vitalenko throws, he connects.
Boy, he is so clean and so accurate. Matsuda really needs to find a way to close the distance, get this fight against the ropes, and get to where he is comfortable.
Time for Matsuda. Take a deep breath. Tries to recalculate his Russian opponent. Making it difficult to land strikes on the feet. Nice level change again. Countered nicely for Bitonenko. Oh, and that was a lovely combination right there. 1-2, connecting flush.
Matsuda trying his best to find the chance for a takedown, but really it is Gritsenko's takedown defense and the counterpunching that is so on point. And when you're in Matsuda's position, this is such a tough place to be. He can't get to the spot where he's comfortable. And he's got to try to do something on his feet, but Mikhail Gritsenko is just a step ahead of him everywhere.
Yeah, just like you said, Brian. Gritsenko getting the read on Matsuda. Lovely body kick there, landing flush. But the toughness of Matsuda is what's keeping him in this match so far. As he refuses to go down and is fighting back with every inch that he has.
Matsuda is still very much in this fight, but he's eating too much damage. He needs to find a way to establish that jab and then get a clean takedown so he can do some work on the ground and avoid these striking positions.
You can't help but think. Constant onslaught. Gritsenko, you see the shot just skimming the side of the cup. Gritsenko is going to get 5 minutes to recover. That's just something that happens. You can't help these things. But just before that, you know, we were talking about the constant pressure of Gritsenko. But just tell us, Brian, what can that do in terms of confidence, knowing that you've hit your opponent with some of your biggest shots for two rounds straight, and the guy just is still in his face?
Oh, his confidence is gonna be through the roof. You know, the real danger is that you get so confident in your striking, everything is landing, that you forget about really the most important piece, which is that defense. He's doing a great job with his footwork, though. He's keeping his hands up and he's moving his head, so he's not displaying any of, you know, the possibility of having forgot about his defense. He's doing a great job with the striking and the control.
Just skimming the side of the cup. Gritsenko gets the equivalent time of the round to see if he can continue. Just as we started to see, Brian, some, I wouldn't say a momentum shift in the fight, but definitely a change in strategy from Matsuda, knowing that he's taken such big shots, knowing that his opponent is still coming forward. What can that mean psychologically for Matsuda?
Matsuda really has to reevaluate his approach to this fight. He's kind of happy to keep duking it out, which is not a good look for him. Someone who's going to be a champion, someone who's going to get that contract, would be able to adapt. And we really need to see that from Matsuda, the ability to adapt to this environment, this change here, and this pressure. Really incredible skill set from his opponent, Mikhail Gritsenko.
Gritsenko from Russia, the Russian hitman. Strong so far in the opening two rounds. there you see the low kick, which really opened up the combinations for his boxing, Brian.
He flowed in from that low kick beautifully. The right hand landing so clean. A little step back, the right and the left. Everything that he throws out there. Another right, another left landing. So clean, and he's staying relaxed. He's getting in and out. He's staying safe with his footwork. Martinez really just not able to pick up any of these strikes.
Let me see your mouth guard. Move back. You okay to go? This is round two. Let's go.
Only the best of the best in the world are invited to one championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. And Ritsanenko starts the third round hard with a combination to the face of Matsuda and a flying knee to follow up. As Matsuda is in zombie mode right now. He's trying to hunt Ritsanenko down, but I don't know yet if he's landed any clean shots yet. Right.
This is the thing, Matsuda is gonna have to take more damage to get into the range that he wants to be in. He probably knows that. Doing it behind a jab would be his safest option. But the thing is, every time he sticks it out there, Ritsanenko was so good at just fading back and then coming back with counters. And then we just saw there in the clinch position, he can throw the flying knee, he can throw the elbows. He really poses a threat at every single range. There's the high kick with the look down. Ritsanenko is looking so good.
Ritsanenko with the pressure, the taunting from Matsuda. Trying to get some energy from the crowd. He's going to need to start dominating. He's going to need to start showing his will to win. Changing strategy. Kimura Tagari double leg, as he might be successful here, taking the back of Ritsanenko. Temporarily now able to launch some kind of attack as he peppers with the knee. Nice Uranage switch down with the drop there to get the back control for Matsuda. And Ritsanenko methodically trying to escape here.
Ritsanenko with great defense in these grappling exchanges. Matsuda wants to be here. This is where he feels strongest. But Ritsanenko showing some great defense in these positions.
Oh, that was a lovely Tayatoshi takedown from Matsuda. A variation coming up of one knee. And the success of the takedown has led to back control here. As Ritsanenko does a Grammy roll out of the back control, but ends up in the side control of Matsuda. Yoko Shiogatami, the holding technique, which is so well known around the world. As Matsuda tries to move towards a Kimura and possibly get a submission finish, and that was tight for a minute as Grishenko was forced to escape there.
The pressure from very skilled judo players when they're on top is immense. This has to be a really bad position for Ritsanenko. What can he do here, Achilles? How can he get out?
He's definitely gonna need to let go of control over the head. That's not helping him so much now. He's gonna need to get on his side and launch some kind of defense. Because right now, Matsuda is utilizing the fact that you're allowed to use your knees to a grounded opponent. And there you see him pinning the arm from the north-south position, the Kamishiogatami position. Again, pinning the right arm of Ritsanenko down, constantly threatening with the submission as he rains down knees on the head of his Russian opponent. And here we see the submission attempt. It's nearly on. That is so tight. He's going to have to change it up here. The pain of Ritsanenko's face as he weathers the storm of this tight Kimura.
Keep up.
My gosh, how flexible can his shoulders be?
This is the position that Kimura held Gracie down in for over 40 minutes before he broke his arm. Matsuda right now in a position where I don't know if Ritsanenko's arm is made of rubber bands, but that position does not look healthy for any normal human being.
Matsuda has taken such great advantage of this position. You talked about the knees on a grounded opponent. They really set up the opportunity for this submission, but he still is not able to finish it. Gritsenko just has gummy, flexible shoulders.
You see him wincing there. The pain is evident. He's got really good flexibility, but Matsuda is doing his best to try and break the arm of Gritsenko. As he keeps the controlling position, 10 seconds left. I don't know how Gritsenko was holding on, but Matsuda knees the mouthpiece out of Gritsenko. Getting on top with the near finish with the Kimura.
How is that arm not broken? You really have to wonder, Achilles, will he be able to punch with it here in the third? Here we see some great knees. Matsuda tying him up, having that back position, keeping the back. So smart with the knees on the grounded opponent, but then locking up this Kimura position. It looked like he could finish. It looked like he had it locked in. Unbelievable that Gritsenko toughed that thing out. I hate to think about what sort of condition his arm is in right now.
Absolute madness in the second round coming into the third. One Friday Fights is an entry-level platform in search of rising talent who can be future world champions. And Matsuda showing his iron grit and will. The Bushido warrior spirit coming back from taking heavy shots to the face from Gritsenko, able to launch his submission attacks in round two.
This round, we will see if Gritsenko is able to use that arm, that right arm, at all offensively. I have my doubts, but Matsuda feeling much more confident after having such a successful second round.
That's a nice single leg attempt. Matsuda unable to get the finish. He takes another clean shot from Gritsenko. The flying knee on the timing on the double leg. Landing flush, but Matsuda just smothering Gritsenko right now with the grappling.
Incredibly, Gritsenko is still using the right arm. He's overhooking. He landed a left hook, but he's signed trying to throw the right as well. Really unbelievable. Matsuda now in this clinch position here with an underhook in the corner. This is probably right where he wants to be. What sort of takedown attempts can he look for from here, Achilles?
He's going to need to start chaining some combinations together. Gritsenko starting to get a read on the takedown attempts of Matsuda. And there, the switch of direction, the Kosotogaki landing on top straight in the Tateshiogatami, the full mount position. Matsuda, heavy judo hips now controlling his Russian opponent.
Great pressure here from Matsuda on the top. You can see he's intertwined his legs with Gritsenko. He's going to stretch him out,
Pressure. Hey, don't speak that mouth guard again. Okay, let's go.
And again, the mouthpiece of Gritsenko coming out from the pressure of Matsuda. This is not where Gritsenko wants to be. Matsuda in the mount with the heavy hips, keeping his Russian opponent down, landing ground and pound. Gritsenko turns the corner and is able to escape as Matsuda relentlessly makes sure that he is the first person back on his feet.
They find themselves back in the corner. Ooh, with the takedown. Can't finish it, and Gritsenko following up the knee. This is the position that he wants to let those hands go.
Again with the Tayatoshi, the combination with the Uranage again. Almost like a wrestling suplex. Matsuda showcasing his beautiful judo skills, getting the right taisabaki, the movement, executing the perfect position, the breaking of the opponent's balance, and executing the throw. Matsuda is on fire in this third round, Brian.
Those scramble situations, those transitions are so important in MMA, and we can see that Matsuda is really feeling comfortable and coming, finishing his takedowns now, getting reversals. He is starting to dominate in those transition positions.
Full mount control for Matsuda. He's dominating his Russian opponent, Kritsanenko. The short elbows from the top. Finding a home for the ground and pound. Giving in the mother's milk here. Suffocating Kritsanenko from the top position.
That top pressure is so uncomfortable. And the elbows don't look huge, but those short elbows are so effective, especially at opening up cuts.
Another nice elbow from the top. The referee is watching the action very closely. He's ready to step in at any moment as Matsuda surges for a finish. Forces Kritsanenko to give him his back as he sinks in a Hadaka Jime, a rear naked choke. But Kritsanenko not ready to go away yet, as he prefers to give up the same position that he was in for the majority of this third round.
10 seconds. Kritsanenko seems nearly impossible to submit, so Matsuda deciding to close out the round with a barrage of punches and knees. He wants to seal the deal on this victory with the judges.
The crowd are in appreciation as these mixed martial arts bouts, the fights are judged as a whole, not round by round. And if you had to say who won that fight, Brian, who would you say?
I have to give it to Matsuda for his surge in the last two rounds here, doing a great job of sticking with the takedown, getting that top position, letting the elbows fly, that top pressure. He made submission attempts, and although he couldn't get them, they were awful close, especially that Kimura in the second round. Here he is almost locking up that rear naked choke, but Kritsanenko proving nearly impossible to submit. Matsuda having to feel very proud and happy about that performance, especially after the first round where Kritsanenko was so dominant. You can see the swelling in Matsuda's eyes from the punches. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of Matsuda. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of Kritsanenko. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision. Seiya Matsuda!
What a performance from the fighter from Fukuoka, Seiya Matsuda, coming back from such a tough first round. Mikhail Kritsanenko was all over him, but Matsuda stuck with it. He toughed it out. Back in the second and the third. Let's go to Achilles for the post-fight interview.
Seiya Matsuda, congratulations. That was an amazing performance. Back and forth action. What is your message for the Japanese fans?
ずっと素晴らしい試合見せてくれました。会場もすごく盛り上がりました。勝ちおめでとうございます。一言、日本人のファンへのお願いします。
Kopenkop! Crazy boy, Japanese crazy boy, Seiya Matsuda. One more Japanese crazy boy, Seiya Matsuda. Coming back, strong, coming back, won championship. Thank you.
Seiya Matsuda, amazing performance. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Seiya Matsuda.
Wow, the man of steel, Seiya Matsuda from Blue Dog Gym in Japan, demonstrating his incredible judo prowess. But don't go anywhere. We have 152-pound Muay Thai coming your way as Tran Quoc Tuong takes on Yuya Jodishi.
As always, Stamp enjoying her best life and doing Muay Thai since she was 5 years of age.
From being a two-sport world champion Muay Thai and kickboxing to being the fastest rising star, arguably in MMA history. And now here she is. It's the Stamp Dance. She is amazing.
ที่ตอนเปิดตัวที่เห็นเหมือนหนูมีความสุขมีหัวเราะยิ้มอะไรพวกนี้หนูพยายามจะเอนเตอร์เทนหลายๆคนคนดูแฟนคลับหลายๆคนสแตมได้เพราะว่าสแตมเป็นสแตมแดนซ์แล้วก็เวลาต่อยก็ต่อยโหดต่อยมันค่ะ
That was it, Yuji. And here are the knees of the midsection from Stan Fairchek. The power! Stan Fairchek is the queen of kickboxing. Stan Fairchek, a succession of red hair. She's made history. A two-sport world champion. This is danger. She got her! Stan Fairchek is the unified world Grand Prix champion.
เพราะว่าความใฝ่ฝันหนูเส้นทางของหนูก็คืออยากจะเป็นแชมป์ MMA แล้วก็อยากจะเป็นหนึ่งในบริษัทที่ว่าได้แชมป์ทั้ง3เส้น
Her progress in MMA has been faster than any other athlete I've seen. There's a mean look on the kisser of Stan.
But it's just what a win for Stan. She makes history and becomes a three-sport world champion.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights. Next week, the biggest One Friday Fight event of the year is here. Two title bouts, longtime rivals, Superbon and Marat Gregorian, fight for the one interim featherweight kickboxing world championship. Global pay-per-view available at watch.onefc.com. But coming up next,We have catchweight 152 pounds Muay Thai as Thant Quoc Tuong takes on Yuya Jodishi. The age and height are identical with a 1.2 pound weight advantage going to Jodishi. This one is Vietnam taking on Japan. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three minute rounds. The 10-point bus system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws or grappling allowed.
From the blue corner, Yuya Jodishi.
Yuya Jodishi from Japan with the 70% win rate. This 28-year-old has a Muay Mat style. That means he likes to use his fists. He likes the combinations. He likes to go for the KO. And he is a specialist in karate. He's got that extensive karate background, specifically in the Goju-Ryu style, Ryan.
That's right, Achilles, that Goju-Ryu style, which is a bit of a mixture of hard and soft karate that he says really influences his style. He has fought in the little gloves in the Muay Thai rule set before and beat a very tough and comparable Thai fighter. He did that in Japan. He's also trained with one of our favorites, Soe Black. So he probably picked up some great tricks there in that training session. He will utilize his footwork. He said he likes his jab and he likes his right straight, but when it comes to karate techniques, he likes that Mikazuki Geri. And if you don't know what that is, it's a little variation on the round kick, the roundhouse. It's like a mixture of a front kick with the ball of the foot and the roundhouse that comes at an angle and it lands on the ribs or the liver, and it is oh so effective, Achilles.
Yuya Donishi planning to get the KO finish tonight. His One Friday Fights debut. Yuya Donishi enters the One Lumpinee ring.
From the red corner, Tran Quoc Tuan!
This young man from Vietnam representing the Saigon Sports Club. They call him the time bomb for a reason. It's about his fighting style, but it derives from the adversity that he had to face of having the premature birth of his son at just 6 months. That is why he called his son Bomb. His son's name is Bomb, and he took after that, called himself the Time Bomb, and he has applied his fighting style to depict that exactly. He likes to be aggressive, he likes to push forward, he's got that extensive amateur background representing the national team of Vietnam in Muay Thai. Brian, I am super excited for this man's debut.
That is right, Achilles. Before embarking on his professional career, over 40 amateur matches in Muay Thai. He's got a ton of experience, a very high pedigree. He loves the low kicks. He loves pressure and big low kicks. He too has experience in the little gloves under the Muay Thai rule set. He's fought like that 4 times in Vietnam. He knows that his opponent is smart and strong, but he wants to slow him down and then work into that clinching range with some elbows and some knees.
Thuan Tran, Vietnam, makes his One Friday Fights debut.
Coming up is 3 3-minute rounds of a 152-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Team High Up, with a fight record of 7-3 and a 70% win rate. Representing Japan, Yuya Donishi. And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Saigon Sports Club, with a fight record of 8-1 and an 89% win rate. Representing Vietnam, Time Bomb Tran Quoc Tuan.
Just. Ready, come.
Athletes competing at One Friday Fights are all gunning for a ticket to the big leagues in the world's largest martial arts organization in one. These two debutantes, they told us they want to become fan favorites. They want to put on a show for the fans here tonight. And already you can see the heavy hands in Tran.
Donishi taking an interesting approach here, keeping the hands very low. Tran blitzing, seeing those hands down and happy to exchange. It is a dangerous game to play with those hands so low. And Tran says, I like it, I'm going to move forward and plow got some ones and twos. Blood already coming from the nose of the fighter from Japan, Joe Nishi.
They call him the time bomb for a reason. And he told us he was going to tee up on Joe Nishi, and he was going to go for the finish. And so far, Tran from Vietnam has kept his word as Joe Nishi goes for a single leg takedown, but I think that's the wrong rule set, Brian.
You are right, Achilles. This is not mixed martial arts. It's Muay Thai. Joe Nishi still continuing to keep the hands low as Tran lands a big one and a big right and sends Onishi down to his knees.
Big shots from Tran, trying to end the night for Joe Nishi. He's gonna need a miracle right now as he takes a big knee. The referee giving him the count.
Surprised Joe Nishi is still keeping the hands low, and Tran is moving into that clinch position that he told us about. Nice push kick. Here he is, Joe Nishi, just trying to pull his head out, which is not an effective technique in the clinching position. Tran letting the pain land. Oh, Joe Nishi comes back with a 1-2 of his own, and Tran is wobbled.
Joe Nishi showing his Bushido spirit with the comeback. Partially dazed Tran, but Tran is back to work as usual, hunting with heavy shots. This is a back and forth brawl.
Joe Nishi not only is keeping the hands low, but he's just keeping his mouth open, letting his jaw hang, which is another big no-no. Tran back in that clinch position. Joe Nishi with just really no answer there.
Tran promised us a KO in round two. 10 seconds left in round one. Is Joe Nishi gonna make it out of this unscathed? I don't think so, because he's taken heavy shots from Tran. Showed his warrior spirit, able to get back up twice to his feet. As Tran from Vietnam makes a statement in his debut here in the opening round, Brian.
Wow, everything he threw landed, but it's little wonder. Joe Nishi keeping the hands low. There is the nice left hook followed by the right, and a few more punches. It sends Joe Nishi down. And then in this clinched position, Tran looking very dominant as well. There was this moment at the end where Joe Nishi landed three nice shots, a right, a left, and a right, and it put Tran on wobbly knees. But other than that, it was all Tran with the barrage of punches. Joe Nishi showing the wear on his face.
This is the kind of motivation that these athletes have. $100,000 can lead to millions of dollars on the biggest stage of martial arts in one. And Tran is a man on a mission, looking to provide a better life for his family as he hunts Joe Nishi down with every breath that he has.
Joe Nishi is doing a good job of moving laterally. I really wish he put his hands up, but he seems to be refusing to do that, so he's gonna continue to eat almost everything that Tran throws. Tran looking like he wants to work into that clinch position, feeling very strong there.
Joe Nishi is throwing nice strikes in here, Brian. He's starting to connect early here. You can see the combinations that he wants to throw, but the constant pressure from Tran is making it difficult for him to just chain techniques together, Brian. What does Joe Nishi need to do to get some success against Tran?
He wants to keep the guard low, so he's gonna have to add in more head movement. The lateral motion is good, but he's gotta move the head in there. A clean 1-2, and another jab from Tran, just rocking the head of Joe Nishi.
Joe Nishi is taking big damage, but he is fighting back, and he finally sees success as he throws Tran from Vietnam with this comeback. Unbelievable total madness right now, Brian.
Insane turn of events. Joe Nishi finding a home for his punches. Tran rocked from those clean shots. shots from John Ishii. It seems like he needs to get hit quite a few times to wake up.
The round two KO finish was promised from Tran. 1 minute left here in the second round. Can he pull off his own prediction? He's going to need to do something different because John Ishii is starting to look strong. Majority of the big shots from Tran right now. Takes a deep breath. Tries to gain some more momentum, but both of these fighters have been through so much already, Brian. What could we possibly be going through their minds?
I like the front kick from Tran. It's a great weapon. It shuts down the lateral motion of John Ishii. He needs to keep punching, pumping that front kick and that jab and move into that clinching range, because really John Ishii has no offense there. It's on the outside. Ooh, nice kick to the right hand. It's on the outside here where John Ishii can do that counter punching and that lateral side to side motion.
John Ishii with a nice follow up from the kick with the straight right, catching Tran with the hands down. It's a nice combination, the way that he threw the kick up effortlessly, followed up with the right stiff. Possible comeback here for John Ishii, as it's two knockdowns for Tran and one for John Ishii.
The big 1-2 from Tran sends the head just careening back from John Ishii, but John Ishii landing some big shots of his own. Here is another clean 1-2 from Tran. John Ishii not keeping the guard up. Ooh, the jab snapping his head back. But John Ishii coming back. He finds those opportunities and really takes advantage of them. This is an interesting spot to be in going into the third round here, isn't it, Achilles?
I mean, the shots that these two have taken from each other are just unbelievable. The fact that they're still standing on their feet just goes to show you that these are high-level elite athletes that dedicate their whole lives to fighting. And a big shot from Tran as he hits John Ishii with the 1-2, flooring him early in the third round.
Very clean from Tran. John Ishii is gonna be hurt, he's gonna be buzzed, but sometimes it appears that this is where he is at his most dangerous.
Tran starting to ragdoll John Ishii now as he shows just how hungry he is to get the finish. Tran is showing just how hungry he is to want to get the highlight reel finish as he's landing big bombs on John Ishii.
John Ishii barely able to stay up, but somehow he does. Oh, taking the knee, and the referee has seen it. No, that fight is over.
Four knockdowns in the entire fight. He calls game over. John Ishii, even though he showed big heart, he just could not stand in there with Thant Zin as he completely obliterated John Ishii in the third round.
You talk about heart, Achilles. John Ishii has loads of it. The body shots from Tran causing John Ishii to crumple. Just the pressure of the left hand touching the chin there. John Ishii overwhelmed by the pressure from the fighter from Saigon Sports Club, Vietnam, Tran Quoc Tuan, looking so good here in his debut. A clean left hook and right straight, digging to the body, coming over the top, getting the job done. John Ishii was so hard to get out of there, but Tran able to do it. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 56 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Tran Quoc Tuan!
Tran Quoc Tuan picking up a very impressive TKO in his debut here. Let's go to Achilles for the post-fight interview.
Tran, that was an absolutely amazing performance. The way that you came out here and showed your heart to all the fans here at One Lumpinee, congratulations. What is your message to the fans in Vietnam?
ครับเราอยู่กับผู้ชนะของเรานะครับทรันนะครับวันนี้เขาสามารถสู้ได้สนุกสุดมันจริงๆเราอยากจะถามความรู้สึกกับการที่จะชนะในวันนี้ครับเขามีข้อความอะไรที่อยากจะบอกถึงแฟนๆที่เวียดนามไหมครับ
Hôm nay em đang rất là tuyệt vời. Em ra đây mọi người đều thấy ý chí của em và quyết sức của em và con tim của em. Em có những gì mà em muốn nói cho người fan ở Việt Nam của em?
Lần đầu tiên em xin cảm ơn đến tất cả khán giả, ban tổ chức và tất cả khán giả đến cổ vũ em. Thứ hai em xin cảm ơn công ty Shadow Entertainment SC đã tạo ra môi trường em tập luyện. Em cảm ơn tất cả những người hâm mộ ở người Việt Nam đã cổ vũ động viên em trong những ngày em qua Thái Lan thi đấu.
First off, I would like to thank the audience. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting and thank you for making noise. I would like to thank my gym, Saigon Sports Club, in Ho Chi Minh City for providing me with a space to train and taking care of me this entire time. And of course, last but not least, I thank you to all the fans who have continued to follow me and continue to support me during my ups and downs.
ก่อนอื่นเลยนะครับเขาอยากจะขอขอบคุณแฟนๆทุกคนที่ให้แรงสนับสนุนขอบเขาในคืนนี้ครับผมอยากจะขอขอบคุณยิมของเขาที่คอยสนับสนุนเขามาโดยตลอดครับ
With a performance like that, it's no surprise that Mr. Chatri Sitiotong has awarded you a 350,000 baht bonus
สู้ด้วยไมค์ขนาดนี้คุณชาตรีบอบบทให้เรา300,000
em xin cảm ơn đến ban tổ chức cảm ơn tất cả mọi người
thank you so much to the organizers thank you so much to one championship and thank you so much to everybody I really appreciate it
เขาอยากจะขอขอบคุณทุกคนครับขอขอบคุณทีมวันแชมเปี้ยนชิพและขอขอบคุณแฟนของเขาทุกคนครับ
ladies and gentlemen your winner Tran Quang Thuong from Vietnam
Tran Quang Thuong looking so good in his debut here on One Friday Fights, getting a beautiful TKO. Let's take a look at that finish again. Just crushing the body of Joe Nishi along the ropes, finding a home for a little left hand over the top, getting another down, forcing the referee to stop the fight. Joe Nishi was so tough and proved to be an incredibly tough opponent. But Tran finishing it off. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We have 140-pound Muay Thai coming up as Mo Tet Ong takes on Tomoya Maruyama.
This guy puts on pressure.
Forward pressure was there. The conditioning was on. His combinations were beautiful. His transitions from the wrestling to the jiu-jitsu was on point as well.
Artem Bela!
Oh, big right hand.
Stop with that one.
Hot elbow. Oh, knees and knees. A jumpy knee. Oh, that might have wobbled. Bela is looking to close the show. And he has it.
One.
Able to get there. Oh,
one. His capital lock in trouble. One. Ew.
Wow. The hype is real on Loman.
Here's the overhead. He's caught him. Swings. It's over.
But Loman goes in for another takedown.
Loman, another takedown on Viviano.
Oh, beautifully done. That's good. Not Irene. Brazilian, so cocky, so confident.
Wonderboy!
Who can stop him?
This Brazilian knockout machine has been on absolute tear.
Patricio Andrazen!
On Saturday, April 6th,
two-sport world champion Raheem Ersel looks to extend his incredible 22-fight win streak against undefeated challenger Alexis Nicholas in a kickboxing world title bout. Plus, the Rutolo brothers are back. Tai and Cade compete in a pair of high-octane submission grappling contests. One Fight Night 21, Ersel versus Nicholas.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights live from Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. The toughest apprentice in the world is back for season two with new locations, new challenges, and new surprises.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
Being at the top of your game is a lonely pursuit. For over a decade, my team and I have built the one brand into a billion-dollar sports media empire. Throughout my life, I've been a warrior in the ring and in the boardroom. Now, I need a champion who can conquer fears, doubts, and insecurities and go to the next level. Across two of the world's most advanced and modern countries, Singapore and Qatar.
Go, Mikey!
10 candidates must prove their mettle in a fear-ignited gauntlet of physical tasks and business challenges.
We want to keep that curiosity.
It's not like customers would realize.
I don't buy food. It's a definite no-go.
In this cutthroat world where like business is a constant war.
Dare to insult me like this. That's it. I don't give a
there can be.
I hate bullies and I hate liars.
Only one winner.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
I need rising superstars who can break new ground and make history. Ready to fight and hungry to win at my side. All fighting for one dream. A $250,000 job offer and the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to work directly with me. Welcome to the world's toughest edition of The Apprentice.
Season two of the critically acclaimed Apprentice One Championship Edition is back and on Netflix in Asia now and coming to the rest of the world later this year. But back here on One Friday Fights, the action continues with catchweight 140 pounds Muay Thai action as Morte Ung takes on Tomoya Maruyama. Maruyama is 5 inches taller and has a slight weight disadvantage. This one is Myanmar taking on Japan. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws or grappling will be allowed.
From the blue corner, Tomoya Maruyama!
Tomoya Maruyama from Wakayama, Japan. 72% win rate. He's 25-year-old, coming from the Buyukai gym in Japan. This is his debut here on One Friday Fights. He's got that boy Densa style, so you know he likes to kick. Used to play football growing up as well, so that will add to the athleticism that this man has. He is a confident man coming into this with high expectations of becoming a champion, Brian.
First thing I have to say, Achilles, is his home prefecture, Wakayama, is truly a hidden gem in Japan. If you haven't been, you have to go. It is beautiful, and it has produced
this incredible fighter right here. He is very comfortable in both of those rule sets, kickboxing or Muay Thai. In Japan, you'll find lots of organizations that sort of blend the two, so he is very comfortable. The most interesting thing that he said when we spoke with him was when we asked him about that fighting style, and we said, you know, how do you fight? What would you call your style, Maruyama? He said, I am a guts fighter. It is all about my fighting spirit. He loves to punch into those elbows, piece those combinations together, finish with the elbows, and he said he feels very comfortable in the little gloves.
The debut of Tomoya Maruyama. He excites that crowd over the top rope. His what? Friday fights debut.
From the red corner, Mao Tse-ang!
Mao Tse-ang! Just take a second to listen to the crowd as the Burmese people are here in force. We got Lee Thue legends on the card tonight. One Friday Fights is kicking this off with some amazing talent. Now, the country of Myanmar has produced some of the most amazing champions. And Mo Tae-ong is definitely one of them. 90% win rate. 26 KOs. This is a man who has come to finish his business.
These fighters from Myanmar are so tough, but they're not just brawlers. They are technical as well and have a very unique style. This is his first time fighting a Japanese opponent. He knows that they have good footwork and punches, but he's confident that his are better. He is a big fan of Roll Tide and loves that style, wants to prove that he can fight like that as well. We asked him what he thought about the little gloves because he's had so many fights under that Letway rule set. He said that he's done some wushu tournaments and he's used similar gloves before, so he's comfortable. He is going to come with the pressure and the fists in this match, Achilles. These guys are so tough. I cannot wait to see this one go down.
Mo Tae-ong wants to entertain the crowd, wants to get the KO, believes in his punching power. He believes he can get the job done tonight as he carries the weight of his country of Myanmar on his shoulder as he enters the one Lumpinee ring for the first time.
Next is three 3-minute rounds of a 140-pound Muay Thai contest presented to you by Monster Energy. Unleash the Beast. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Buyukai with a fight record of 13-5 and a 72% win rate. Representing Japan, Tomoya Maruyama. Out of the red corner, training out of Family Wanchuchai with a fight record of 32-1 and a 97% win rate. Representing Myanmar, Mo Tae-ang.
Okay, you both understand the rules. Listen to me at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. If you want to touch gloves now. Good luck. Back to your corners. Judge,
suspense in the stadium is evident.
Ready?
As these fighters are fighting for a $100,000 contract and an invitation to the big stage in the world, which can lead to millions of dollars in one, the highest pinnacle of martial arts on the planet. Mo Tae-ong going to
Obama.
These guys are training hard and fast right off the bat. You can see Maruyama there in the southpaw stance. He's going to be looking for that left hand to land and the left kick. Muay Thai Om with his right hand and his right kick.
Muay Thai Om, he told us this is the first time fighting a Japanese fighter. Although he breaks the footwork, he believes that his punching power gives him the count for the knee there.
Yeah, big knee there from Maruyama. Really taking advantage of his height differential and finding a home for that knee. That has to be a really big boost to his confidence here in the first round.
Big shot in response there. There was an accidental right poke.
Okay,
just like you said, Brian, the range, the reach advantage for Maruyama. He's been using that arm to keep at bay and then going straight into the clinch when we saw him use the knee earlier.
It's a great weapon for Maruyama. Both of these fighters wanting to duke it out, probably not do a lot in the clinch, but that mid-range for Maruyama, he's so tall, he can sneak that knee up there inside of the punches for Muay Thai Om.
Maruyama getting the advantage in the clinch, starting to throw elbows as Muay Thai Om throws a big shot and a big elbow as they collide and clinch up again.
Some punishment, but you know, doing some work to the body and to the legs early could pay some dividends and setting up opportunities for those big overhands at close range.
That was a big leg kick from Muay Thai Om, forcing Maruyama to get on his bicycle again. With the clinch work on the ropes, nice elbows. Muay Thai Om yet to look worried as he weathers the storm of Maruyama.
Maruyama is a champion back in Japan, and he is really showing why he is a champion, using his elbows and his knees so effectively, really adapting at this close range fight. But Motet's still so dangerous, coming in with the right hand narrowly missing.
Big shots thrown by the Burmese fighter in the first round. Tactical approach for Maruyama as he landed most of the significant strikes. How do you see that first round, Brian?
I think Maruyama found a home for the weapons that he needed to use in this close range battle. Popping the jab. Here is the knee, clean on the button, just taking the feet right from under Muay Thai Om. There, a big right hand from the fighter from Myanmar. That was a sharp round for Maruyama. I think he found the range that he wants to engage at and the weapons that he wants to use, Achilles.
Established fighters or up-and-comers who want to earn a shot at the highest levels in the world in the fraction of one champ, they need to show dominance. They need to show that they're hungry for the victory. Is what Muay Thai Om and Maruyama are doing. These two warriors are going to battle as the elbow from the top just skimmed the side of the face of the Burmese fighter there, Brian.
Maruyama is looking very confident and very happy to exchange in these close ranges, these clinching exchanges. He just needs to be very careful and watch for the uppercuts and overhands of Muay Thai Om, because those are always going to be dangerous.
Maruyama again with the relentless clinch work. Knees coming from the left, from the right, through the middle. All kinds of trouble for Muay Thai Om from Myanmar.
Maruyama using, the hands from Muay Thai Om sneaking through. Mariano is using some cute skipping knees in the corner to rack up points. Not a lot of damage, but he's really happy to play a bit of a heel character here in the ring today. Motet Ungo displaying his power and those iron fists from Myanmar.
Oh, these fists are just piercing the defense of Maruyama like missiles, Brian. The way that he's throwing that straight, and that looping left hook as well. But Maruyama, a technician at heart, has the strategy, so good at sticking to the strategy. And will it prove to be too much for Monteo in the end?
Maruyama just has a great game plan here. He's adapted well to the situation. He's a tricky southpaw. He's gonna eat a little damage every now and then, but if he can avoid the big blows, he can get back to this clinching position and rack up points with skipping knees and score big points with some knees to the chin. Achilles, you said before the show that the fans from Myanmar were really gonna come out tonight, and you were not kidding. My gosh, you can really hear them roaring for their fighter, Mo Tat Hong.
This right here is so important. Monteo starts to find the temple of Maruyama, but Maruyama showing his ferociousness, landing clean combinations. Great work from Maruyama so far.
He gets on the inside, and he lets the knees and the elbows go so well. It's these moments when they break apart, or when Monteo lunges in. Right at the bell, landing clean on Maruyama's chin, snapping his head back.
Oh, you cannot sleep on the striking of Monteo. Even though he took lots of damage from Maruyama, who seems to be getting outpointed, but he will not give up on his strategy. He is going for the game-ending blows with every shot, Brian.
Giant overhand left there from Mo Tet Ung, digging the body, but eating knees as well. Mo Tet Ung landing the right hand there too. He needs to get inside. He needs to find a way to land one of those big bombs. He's gonna have to weather the storm a little bit, take some blows, but the trade-off will be worth it if he can connect on the chin of Maruyama.
Come on!
So much excitement. One Friday Fights is an entry-level platform in search of rising talent who can be future world champions. And both Maruyama and Monteo are showing the kind of quality that could potentially be champions here. Oh, and another big shot as Monteo lunges in, constantly trying to finish Maruyama.
Monteo definitely has the power advantage. Maruyama has the volume advantage. He's making great use of those dropping, chopping elbows and the knees attacking from both angles. As long as he can keep his chin safe, he can stick to the plan and ride out this round. It really comes down to Mo Tet Ung being able to find a home for one of those big shots over the top.
Big body shot. Clinch work, just smothering Monteo.
I like the way that Monteo has been attacking the body. It brings Maruyama's guard down, and it creates an opening for a shot over the top. But there's only a minute and a half left in this round. He's kind of got to go for the Hail Mary.
Oh, a big shot over the top for Maruyama. Tries to end the fight with defensive footwork and the high kicks, but just skims past the head of Monteo.
Both fighters trading lefts and rights there. This fight is all drama right up into the last minute. Monteo looking for the uppercut. Maruyama moving his head and then moving with the hook and back to the knees and the elbows.
Monteo. Shot and land the shot.
a big shot. Up top is Monte Ong. Hunts for the finish. Body shots to follow. The crowd are going nuts right now. 30 seconds remain. The third and final round.
This is the moment that Monte Ong has been waiting for. Can he take advantage of it? Maruyama knows that he's hurt, but he's doing a good job of tying on it.
Let's watch that again. Some more elbows from Maruyama. Yama coming down. But Mo Dae-Ung finding the right over top, then the left, then the right, then the left again. There is a sharp and precise right hand from the fighter from Myanmar, catching Maruyama right on the chin here with the right and the left and the right. Fighting for the fans in the crowd here was the fighter from Myanmar, so clean with the lean back and that sharp right catching Maruyama perfectly, forcing the referee to stop the fight. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
This match was presented to you by Monster Energy. Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 50 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Mo Tae-Ung!
Mo Tae-Ung with an explosive debut here on One Friday Fights. The crowd is going absolutely wild. Let's go to Achilles for the post-fight interview.
Mo Tae-Ung, congratulations. That was an amazing performance. The way that you came back from adversity was absolutely stunning. What do you have to say for all the fans in Myanmar and all the Burmese fans that have come here to see you today?
วันนี้นะครับเราอยู่กับผู้ชนะของเรานะครับโมตัดอึงนะครับผมก็วันนี้นะครับเป็นการต่อสู้ที่สนุกสุดมันจริงๆสามารถกลับลุกขึ้นมาได้หลายรอบมากๆอยากจะถามเขาครับว่าเขามีคำถามมีคำพูดหรืออยากจะบอกอะไรเกี่ยวกับแฟนๆของเขาที่อยู่ในสนามตอนนี้และแฟนๆที่รับชมจากที่ประเทศพม่าครับ
เขาก็จุดดีกว่านายอาชีพเราจุดน้องกูจุดน้องก็อยู่บ้านเลยจุดน้องป่วยสิสิไปแล้วกูผิวเหว่ยจุดน้องเสียแต่มาได้อาลอยจุดน้องแล้วที่ท่านมึงก็ย้ายจูซ่าทำไมลูกพี่เขาจีบมาดีกว่าประเทศเดียว
I want to say I'm proud of myself because I'm winning this match, and I want to thank you to everyone, and I want to thank you to my teacher, and I want to say thank you to everyone, one championship.
เขาบอกว่าเขาเชื่อในตัวเองครับที่ทำให้เขาสามารถกลับมาลุกซึ่งสู้ต่อในคืนนี้ได้อยากจะขอขอบคุณทุกคนครับ one championship และแฟนๆของเขาทุกคนครับ
With a comeback victory like thatChatree Sitiotong has awarded you a 350,000 baht bonus.
นักสู้ที่ไม่ยอมแพ้แบบนี้ครับคุณชาติบ้อมมอนให้เรา 350,000 บาทครับ
ชื่อชื่อไปแล้วประเทศอะไรจีนอ่ะยะชื่อชื่อที่บ้านแล้วพี่ชื่อบ้านเลย
I want to say thank you to the fans and the everyone from here.
เขาอยากจะขอขอบคุณแฟนๆของเขาทุกคนที่คอยให้กำลังใจเชียร์เขาในคืนนี้ครับ
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Mo Tae-Ung!
Mo Tae-Ung looking explosive in his debut, picking up that bonus from Mr. Chatree Sitiotong. There it is, leaning back on the right hook from Maruyama, the perfect counter, that right straight, right on the pipe.That is textbook as good as it gets. And Mo Tae-Ung showing what these fighters from Myanmar are made of. But ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. We have Bantamweight Muay Thai coming your way as O-Top 10.
takes on Parham Gerati.
One Friday fight continuing to change the landscape of Muay Thai and martial arts. Everybody off their feet inside this Lumpinee Boxing Stadium.
Talk about a young gun who is just a phenomenal athlete. And this is her, Jackie Buntan.
She's a multi-time American Muay Thai champion.
The speed, the precision, the timing.
She's got very fast hands. She's got powerful kicks. She can go forward and she can go back.
Jackie Buntan turns on the show. That caught her clean. The speed again. Fast up to the speeding ticket.
Woo!
Oh, left hand tags her.
Jackie Buntan.
The swag that she comes out with. She's got confidence and she's ready to go.
The volume and the precision of Buntan that is just completely confounding.
That was a beautiful combination landed by Buntan.
So young and just complete ownership. Oh, hell taste my feet, says Jackie Buntan.
They're throwing him now. Good stuff here. Huge combination.
Everything is textbook Muay Thai 101.
24-year-old American Jackie Buntan, and a huge night for her tonight here on home soil. Jackie Buntan with a first-round knockout here in America.
Wow, what a statement made.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights here at the iconic Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Up next, we have Bantamweight Muay Thai action as Otop takes on Parham Gerati. Gerati is 3 years older, 1 inch taller, and the weight is identical. This one is Thailand taking on Iran. We're going global rules Muay Thai, that's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws or grappling will be allowed.
From the blue corner, Parham Gerati!
See the return of Gerati. He's got such an exciting style, and that is why he has two back-to-back victories here on One Friday Fights. And he told us he's happy with his last performance. He was against a tough opponent, and he really showed us that he's not just a knockout artist, Brian. He knows what it needs to take to get the win.
He told us that he was a bit surprised. He's only 20 years old. But his opponent is actually 3 years younger than him, 17. So he said, I haven't fought someone younger than me. So he was a little thrown off by that. He told us that he wants the KO early, of course, but he's got a strategy as well to outpoint his opponent if he needs. So he's covering both of his bases. He said, I know my opponent is young, but my opponent has been finished in Lumpinee Stadium before, and that plays to my benefit. So I will do some headhunting when I'm close, but at that long range, I am gonna let the kicks go and build up some points when I can. He said his best weapon is not any of his strikes, it's his pressure and his ability to break his opponent.
You know, he told us, Brian, that he will be hunting for the jaw of Otop. He's
going to try and get the KO early. He will be ready for a three-round war. He's predicting a first-round knockout with either a punch or an elbow combination. Arham Garati. His final thoughts before he enters the One Lumpinee ring for the third time.
From the red corner, Alta!
Born and raised in Ubon Ratchathani, fighting out of the esteemed Soe Samai gym in Bangkok, Thailand. Otop is here for the fourth time. Saying that this young man is about to graduate high school and he wants to go to university, so it's very important for him to be keep being successful and use Muay Thai as a means to provide for himself and his family, as a means to pay for his university education. This man has plans for his future, and one of those plans is to become a champion, Brian. And he told us that he is thankful to be back. He worked a lot on controlling his temperament and the special training with the strength and conditioning.
He may only be 17 years old, but he has over 80 fights, a huge wealth of experience for someone his age. And you are exactly right, Achilles. He said that he's learned to be calm, to control his temper in the ring. His training is more systematized now. He's working on the punching. He's working on the footwork and the cardio. He feels strong. The running has helped him. It's built up his lungs. He is ready to go the distance if he needs to in this fight. He knows that his opponent has a very tough style and a strong body shot, but he questions his cardio. He told us the most important attribute for a fighter is discipline, and I believe it. This man is disciplined right here.
A return of Otop on One Friday Fights. As these warriors prepare for battle, they perform a ritual which is used to pay respect to their teachers, to their families. It's a time for these fighters to prepare themselves both mentally, physically, for what they are about to endure. Arham Garati from Iran faces Otop in bantamweight Muay Thai. It's important that they go through the process of the Y Crew, that they can be in the right mindset to go through what could be the hardest fight of their lives. Rituals conclude, giving of the water for the corner. Final prayer. As the coaches give their blessing for this matchup, the Mongkon is removed as we prepare for battle.
Now, we have three-minute rounds of bantamweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Pet Saman Gym, representing Iran, Parham Garati. And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Soe Lin Oo, with a fight record of 64-17 and a 79% win rate, representing Thailand, Outer!
คู่นะชกให้เต็มที่นะมีน้ำใจนักกีฬาล้มไม่ฟังไม่ตามฝ่าคนที่ฝ่ายเข้ามุม
One Friday Fights is the place for dreams to come true and to get a $100,000 invitation to the big leagues, the world's largest stage of martial arts. As Garati from Iran steps in the one Lumpinee ring and tries to make it a hat-trick of three wins in a row as he lands heavy bombs to the jaw of Otop early in the first round.
Garati already has Otop in a bad way here with his hands, doing a great job of putting the pressure on early, going the left and the right and attacking the legs. Otop needs to get on his bicycle and get off the ropes.
That was a good counter there from Otop. As the high kick from Garati skipped and missed, but back to the forward pressure of Garati, which we have known to see as relentless here on one Lumpinee. Every time Garati steps in the ring, and he shows his true worth, and the big shot from up top completely puts Otop to sleep.
Oh my gosh, what can you say? Garati said that his best weapon was his pressure, but I don't know, Achilles, it might be that right hand. What an unbelievable finish early in the first round here for the fighter from Iran, Parham Garati, displaying his pressure, his punching prowess right off the bat. He had Otop on the ropes, leads with the left hook, then throws the looping right after. It finds a home right on the chin of Otop and sends him crashing to the mat. Here it is, one more time. Left and a right. Here is another angle on another series. Garati putting that pressure on, using his elbows, then his knees. Otop firing back with the elbow. But here is the finishing combination, that left hook and that right hook. The perfect setup and the perfect finish. Nothing Otop could do. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 2 seconds in the first round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Parham Garati!
Parham Garati picking up his third win here on one Friday Fights in devastating fashion over a very tough opponent. Let's go to Achilles.
Parham Garati, that was an absolutely amazing performance. The way you came out so fast and finished your opponent, was that part of the game plan?
ครับผมวันนี้เราอยู่กับผู้ชนะของเรานะครับพาฮานนะครับผมการต่อสู้ของเขาในวันนี้เนี่ยแสดงความดุเดือดให้เราเห็นตั้งแต่ยกแรกเลยเลยอยากจะถามครับว่านี่เป็นแผนที่วางมาหรือเปล่าครับ
بله خیلی تمرین کرده بودم واسه این لحظه و اینکه حریفم آنالیز کرده بودم با کسایی که تو تیمم هستن بهم کمک میکنن من میدونستم که چجوری باید به این عادی حریف حمله کنم میدونستم که باید از اول محکم شروع کنم
I practiced a lot and I had plans yes so I analyzed with my team so I knew how need to be aggressive so I get this result
เขานะครับบอกว่าตัวเขาเองเนี่ยครับมีการฝึกฝนอย่างหนักกับทีมของเขานะครับผมแล้วเขาวางแผนมาหลายแบบมากแต่หนึ่งในแผนนั้นก็คือแสดงความดุดันเพื่อหา KO ให้เร็วที่สุดเท่าที่จะทำได้ครับ
With a fantastic performance like that, it's no surprise that you have received a bonus of 350,000 baht from Mr. Chatri Sitotong.
แสดงความดุดันแล้วก็ชนะน็อกเอาท์แบบนี้คุณชาติบอมบอลได้350,000 บาทครับ
Thank you so much, Boss Chatri. Thank you, everyone, to help me for today. Thank you, my coach, Black, Superman, Samart, always with me. Thank you, everyone, to help me. Thank you, my team, always. They come to support me. Thank you, Kapun Kap Chatri.
เขาอยากจะขอขอบคุณคุณชาตินะครับและทีมวันแชมเปี้ยนชิพนะครับแล้วก็โค้ชของเขาแล้วก็แฟนๆของเขาทีมงานที่มาคอยให้กำลังใจของเขาในคืนนี้ครับ
Ladies and gentlemen, show some love for Parham Gerati.
The fighter from Iran picking up his third win and second bonus here at one Friday fights. Let's see it again. The left hook to the right hook.Right on the chin, sending Otop crashing to the mat. It's a beautiful textbook punching combination. He said that he came prepared for the knockout to also win on points. He covered all his bases, but all he really needed was that left and that right to close the deal.Ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. Coming up, we have Bantamweight Muay Thai in our featured fight as Fabio Reis takes on Soe Lin Oo. The Swedish storm has arrived in one.
Smila puts that vice-like grip and to the body. Folds her in half like origami. Oh, second knockdown. This is not good. The corner telling Diandra, you've got to return. Oh, smack bang, the left hand, it's over. Smila Sundell, welcome to one Super Series.
Supergirl is a tremendous striker. Wow.This was a thing of beauty. Look at that.
Lopez already under a lot of pressure. That was a huge right hand, and the referee has already seen enough.
The precision, the technique on this lady, it leads to a lot of knockouts. Good right here from one. The girl dropped to the right hand. Smack bang on the kisser. The first knockdown. And here comes one. The girl again. Thoroughly in trouble. She goes down.Anissa Mixon is an absolute beast inside the ring. Oh, head kick. That was a ripper from Anissa Mixon. Backs her off with the right hand. There's another right hand, but here comes Morales. Rocks the head back again. The volume, and down goes Morales. Anissa Mixon absolutely blasts Morales here in a one Super Series debut.China's Mongbo, perhaps the heaviest hands of any woman in one championship dragon. Oh, smack bang! The big come on! My word, that right hand, Mitch.
Welcome back to one.Friday fights here at the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Coming up next, we have that feature fight of the night in bantamweight Muay Thai as Fabio Reis takes on Soe Lin Oo. Soe Lin Oo is 6 years older, 1 inch shorter, and has a slight weight disadvantage. This one is Portugal versus Myanmar. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws, no grappling allowed. It's a clash of styles. Muay Thai versus Lithway as stars from Myanmar and Portugal face off next.
Man of Steel, Soe Lin!
เราว่าเราจุนโนดว่าโอ้ปีนี้ได้ไต้หวันมาฮู้บ่เนาะจุนโนดมาเล่นลูกเล่นสาวบอกว่ามีเนี่ยจุนโนดจีบีลาเนี่ยนี่อะไรบ่เนาะโอ้ด้านจีดอมนี่อะจุนโนดดูที่อะด้านเราไปบ่เนาะมาเนี่ยเนี่ยมีผีดีเนี่ยจุนโนดเล่นดีเล่าจ้าเลยมีเอวที่ดีเข้าจ้าวิโดมีด้วยดีบาดีบ่เนาะอะไรเนี่ยจุนโนดเล่าสาจ้าเนี่ยเนาะอยู่ในเนี่ยยาวเราจุนโนดดีเลวีอากาศเราจุนโนดวันน่ะปาลาบ่เนาะอากาศ
What ignites my passion to fight is the goals that I set for myself. I want to become a champion. I want to become a role model. I want people to see me as an inspiration. My life is already better because of Juan, but with the contract I will be able to show people in Portugal and all around the world that you can come to Thailand and work hard, start from the bottom and work your way up until you reach your goals. Soe Lin Oo is a man of steel, but I am sensational, and I believe I'm going to give a sensational performance and do a sensational win.
From the blue corner, Soe Lin Oo!
Oh, just take a second to soak all that noise in as the fans from Myanmar are here to support their hero, the man of steel. Soe Lin Oo, fighting from the Mon State out of Myanmar. This man is a living Lin Oo legend. 96% win rate, 72 wins, 69 out of those 72 wins were by knockout. And judging from his debut, where he won the bonus, Soe Lin Oo is a knockout artist, but he is not just that, he is also a community leader back in a small village in Myanmar. He provides for the locals there by being a fighter through his career as a fighter. A truly amazing story, Brian.
Achilles, out of all the fighters that we've spoken to, there is maybe only one person that is even more humble and more kind than Avatar, and that is this man right here, Soe Lin Oo. He is so tough, so incredibly tough, but has an absolute heart of gold. Talking to him about the fight, he knows that his opponent is a formidable puncher as well. And so he said, I want to make use of my low kicks and my elbows. I want to use the weapons where my opponent isn't strong. He also feels better in these little gloves after making his debut and getting that big win over Masayoshi Tsuhashi.
Soe Lin Oo makes his return to One Friday Fights. He goes over the top rope, prepares for battle.
From the red corner, Fabio Reis!
From Portugal, fighting out of the Team Medisantu in Pattaya, Fabio, a sensational race, and there is a reason why they call him sensational. He has had some sensational KO finishes here on One Friday Fights against some very tough opponents, including Ferrari, Vertex, and Sangmani. And if it's because of his work ethic, his coach told us that he is the type of fighter that just puts in the hard work in the gym that's necessary. He is the first one in and the last to leave.
He has incredible wins here on One Friday Fight over elite opposition. A knockout over Sangmani, a knockout over Ferrari, and they all come by that left hook. He has an incredible left hook. And when we spoke to him, he said that he knew that Soe Lin Oo has those great hands as well. So he wants to use his kicks to stop the onslaught, to stop the pressure, to set up his own punching offense. We will see if he will be able to pull that off, because if he can find a home for that left hook, we know it will be a very good night for the fighter from Portugal.
Fabio Reis has made the necessary sacrifices to get to this point as he enters the One Lumpinee ring for the fifth time.
Up next, we have three-minute rounds of Bantamweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Doyoyar Lightweight Club, with a fight record of 72-3 and a 96% win rate. Representing Myanmar, Man of Steel, Soe Lin Oo! And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Team Medizatu, with a fight record of 22-8 and a 73% win rate. Representing Portugal, Fabio Sensational Reis!
Okay, you both understand the rules. Listen to me at all times, protect yourselves at all times. If you want to touch gloves now. Judge.
One Friday Fights is the global platform in search of rising world championship talent to join the greatest roster of world championship strikers in one. Soe Lin Oo has that legend status in Myanmar, a bona fide lightweight legend. The Sensational Reis has become a fan favorite here on One Friday Fights. I have been excited for this matchup all week, Brian.
Ooh, and there is a sharp left hook from Reis right off the bat. Ladies and gentlemen, do not blink. Both of these fighters are absolute knockout machines.
Soe Lin Oo doing what we've seen him do before. Trying to feel out the power of his opponent. Soe Lin Oo is so durable. He can take some of the biggest shots that we saw him take in his debut against Suhashi. But Reis is a different kind of beast.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he is a proven knockout artist.
3 minutes to return to action.
And I need to take a little break here, just to check if his eyes are okay to continue. So he may need the duration of a round to take the break here.
Accidental eye poke there in Fabio Reis' eyeball. Ooh, you can see the finger slipping in, completely unintentional, but it happens. Reis getting some time to recover. Up until that point, he was doing some great work with his left hook to the body. A very smart tactic to use in this matchup, just putting some money in the bank right away.
Right, you know, Fabio Reis is so tough. You can tell he just wants to get right back to the action. And if you've ever been poked in the eye, you will know how it feels. It's a very sensitive area, so it does take a minute or two to recover if the damage isn't too great.
That's right, Achilles. Vision is so important in the striking game as well. Picking up punches and movement. Here we see it again. The finger connecting with the eyeball, but Reis is saying now he's all right.
Let's go. Let's go.
And they can get this thing back on.
Back to that action on One Friday Fights. Soe Lin Oo from Myanmar against Fabio Reis from Portugal. This is the feature bout of the night. So much suspense riding on this matchup. so much support from Myanmar. Soe Lin Oo, as he encourages Reis to come forward, he is looking for a fight to play.
Reis looking very clean in the beginning of this round, sticking the jab, lunging in with the elbow, but there's a shot from Soe Lin Oo right off the bat. It is unbelievable the way this man's hands connect and put people down.
Reis is going to need something special to stay in this, as Soe Lin Oo is hunting for the finish. Uppercut straight up the middle as he has Reis on the ropes.
One touch from Soe Lin Oo to put you on rubber knees.
Oh, the slicing elbow from the top there from Soe Lin Oo as he continues to hunt Reis down. Shots to the body, forcing Reis on the back foot, just overwhelming him with a barrage of pinpoint combinations, Brian.
My gosh, Achilles, listen to the crowd. They are going wild. We knew it was a possibility, but I didn't think it would happen so soon. So Leo is so tough, and he's moving forward behind those shots, driving into Fabio, who is still looking like he's feeling the impact from that punch earlier.
The fists were flying non-stop for the Burmese Lethwei legend. He makes a statement in the first round. Had Fabio Reis on skates. Almost finished the fight. Beautiful leg kick to work. So beautiful to watch this man fight, Brian.
Beautiful left hook there from Reis. But crossing jabs. Soe Lin Oo connecting so clean. And it was that right hand there, the follow-up punch, that sent Fabio to the mat. Those hands of Soe Lin Oo are made of iron. Absolute steel in those fists, Achilles.
This is the kind of action that we expect from the man of steel. These two warriors are clashing for a staggering $100,000 contract and an exclusive ticket to the world's largest martial arts organization. And Soe Lin Oo is enjoying himself in there. As he told us, he wants to entertain the crowd. He wants to put on a show, and he wants to get the finish tonight.
You can tell by the sounds in this arena, this stadium here at Lumpinee, that the crowd is being entertained. Every time Soe Lin Oo throws a punch, the crowd goes wild.
Fabio Reis able to recover after round one. Gonna need a change in strategy. He's gonna go toe to toe with the Lethwei legend, Soe Lin Oo. As he is having fun in there right now. Urging Reis to come forward. These two. Just jousting non-stop, Brian.
Fabio Reis using smart tactics here, kicking the legs of Soe Lin Oo and slowing him down, kicking up to the body. This is what he talked about doing, using his kicks to slow the onslaught. But he's got to be oh so careful. All it takes is one touch from the fighter from Myanmar to totally disturb your plans.
Good job from Reis so far. I was about to say, settling down as he takes the stiff left jab from Soe Lin Oo.
Hey, look at me.
Big stiff jab from Soe Lin Oo as he consistently hunted his opponent down, finally getting the finish that he was looking for.
To hang with his power, and boy, he was not kidding. It is incredible what this man can do with just a jab. Let's watch that again. There it is, the incredible timing on that left hand, picking his moment beautifully. sticking the jab, sending Fabio crashing to the mat again. The referee stopping the fight, seeing Fabio on those rubber knees. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 42 seconds in the second round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Soe Lin Oo!
Soe Lin Oo with a legendary performance, taking his win streak here on One Friday Fights to 2-0. There you see the masterwork from the Burmese fighter. The straight left as he bit down on his mouthpiece. Threw the hand out, and it was almost as if he knew in his heart that he was gonna end this match with a knockout. It was just a matter of time. Ladies and gentlemen, we still have 5 Muay Thai bouts remaining, including Panrit versus Alexey Balyko, 2 surging fighters in a main event that is guaranteed to be a candidate for fight of the night. If this is the end of the broadcast in your region, not to worry. Catch the rest of the fights on the One Championships YouTube channel. For everyone else, the fights will continue after the break.
Continuing to change the landscape of Muay Thai and martial arts. Everybody off their feet inside this Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. Oh my goodness! With the one shot, one kill! What a highlight reel, bang on the chin!
And it's over, and the fans love it!
Out of the cage, I'ma get him.
If you've never seen Fabrizio Andrade compete before, you're about to find out why they call him Wonder Boy.
His range, his timing were superb.
The most complete fighter on the planet right now.
Is a high-level striker. And then once he gets you hurt, those finishing instincts kick in and he goes hunting to end you. He's so aggressive. He's got pinpoint striking.
This young man is one of the most exciting in the sport.
Fabrizio Andrade is the real deal.
Here's the heavy artillery.
Shut it down. Wow.
Who gonna try me? The much anticipated grudge match in the bantamweight division. Fabrizio Andrade. The time is now and he couldn't possibly be more ready.
Oh, big shot.
Baker needs to tie him up here. Get a prayer.
And another from Andrade.
The emotions from the new champ.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights, live from the iconic Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Hello, I'm Achilles Reilly, and I'm still here with the kickboxing legend, Brian McGrath. It has been an amazing night of fights so far, but we have so much more for the fans at home, including this headline main event as Panrit takes on Alexey Balyko.
Both of these fighters are coming off finishes and collecting bonuses. Balyko needs to cut off the ring and utilize his silky smooth boxing. Panrit needs to avoid that boxing range and use his elbows and his knees. I cannot wait for this fight.
Guaranteed madness in that main event. But before that, super excited for the 132-pound Muay Thai debutants, Chalongsuk taking on Donking. But coming up next,
we have a catchweight 112-pound Muay Thai bout as Sungprab takes on Yodnamnuea. Yodnamnuea is 1 year older, 3 inches taller, and has a slight weight advantage. This one is Thailand taking on Thailand. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. 10-point bus system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws, no grappling allowed. Let's keep things rolling on What Friday Fights.
From the blue corner, Yodnamnuea!
A 22-year-old born and raised in Nakhon Ratchasi Ma, the eastern part of Thailand. Yodnamnuea is coming in hot on an 83% win rate. This man is making his debut here on One Friday Fights. If there's anything he could say about Yodnamnuea, it's that Muay Thai has guided him to a better life. Muay Thai has been the means for him to support himself and his family. He's got that Muay Bull style, so that basically means he is all about action and pressure and moving forward to get that finish, Brian.
Achilles, he has a Muay Bu style, but you could almost call it Muay crazy. This fighter loves to throw down. And really, the key to victory in this match is gonna be his ability to do that. He knows that his opponent is strong and durable. But when we asked him to appraise him, he said, I think my opponent has a bit of a weak spirit. He doesn't have that fighting spirit like I do. He said, I want to trade punches with him, and I want to break him. This guy is never in a boring fight. He loves to entertain the fans, and he is gonna be happy to meet in the middle of the ring and exchange, which he is oh so good at. And he can do it with the fists, the elbows, or the knees.
A wealth of experience for this young man as he enters the One Lumpinee ring for the first time here at One Friday Fights.
From the red corner,
born out of Surin, Thailand, fighting out of Lumpinee Gym. It's a small gym. He's proud to be from that. He's already seen success. His debut here on One Friday Fights, earning the KO victory and earning the bonus. In round two against Phet Mun Thai, that was a tough opponent. He used that bonus to pay for his education, to pay off the debts of his parents. He told us that he has improved his KO style so that it can accommodate the rule sets here on One Friday Fight. This is an exciting fighter to watch, ladies and gentlemen. Do not blink on this man.
Like you said, Achilles, he has already seen success in this ring, but that has not stopped him from attempting to improve and adapt his style. He's been working on his defense and his power. He's done some strength training. He knows that his opponent has a similar style and that he's durable, but he thinks that he's just a little too wild, that he doesn't have great defense or accuracy. So what Sungprab wants to do is work his way in with the punches, get to that close range clinching position, and let some elbows go. He thinks the elbow is gonna be a good shot for him to find a potential knockout.
Final prayer here.
Step into the ring.
Sungprab, as he prepares for battle. Very impressive performance that we saw from him, getting the KO victory. And it's the bonus that these fighters strive to achieve. It's the contract that they all lust for. These are the steps that they need to make to get to that point. They need to put it all on the line. And that is what Sungprab is here to do.
Now, we have 3 3-minute rounds of a 112-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of NNP Boxing, with a fight record of 50-10 and an 83% win rate. Representing Thailand, Yodnamnuea! And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Lumpinee, with a fight record of 60-15 and an 80% win rate. Representing Thailand, Songpandin.
แต่มือแต่มือต้องพูดนะโชคให้เต็มที่นะมีน้ำใจในกีฬาไม่ซ้ำไม่ฟาวสั่งหยุดหยุดสั่งแยกแยกนะโชคดี
We are in the place where lives can be changed. Securing a $100,000 ticket to the world's largest martial arts organization is what every fighter dreams of. Sungprab and Yodnamnuea have a chance to showcase their skills at the highest level as the combination lands flush for Sungprab.
Yodnamnuea not wasting a second.To march forward with the high guard, but he's got to be careful. Sungprab is so sharp with those punches, especially that right hand and check left hook.
Just like we've seen so many times before, the debutants come in and they like to play with fire. And Yodnamnuea gets put down to the canvas, and he's gonna need something big to recover from this one.
A laser beam of a right hand.Sungprab, he's got his opponent in the corner and got him hurt. This is exactly where he wants another right hand lands and a few more. And he sends Yodnamnuea to the mat. And this fight is over.
A blistering start for Sungprab as he ends the night early. But Yodnamnuea earning him his second victory here.On one Friday Bites, the improved KO style, the strength and conditioning proved to be beneficial as Sungprab comes away with the victory.
Let's take another look. Blistering right hand. Sungprab got his opponent against the ropes.And unleashed a relentless onslaught, getting the job done beautifully. They both go for the right there. Sungprab pulling his head just off the line, throwing his own, pushing his opponent into the corner, not giving him any route to escape. The right hand landing clean and flush.Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 6 seconds in the first round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Sungprab!
Sungprab picking up another KO.Victory. That makes it 2 in a row. Let's go to Achilles for the post-fight interview.
Sungprab, that was an amazing performance. You started so fast, finished the match early. Was that part of the game plan?
วันนี้นะครับสังปราบครับสู้ได้สุดยอดจริงๆนะครับออกมาแสดงความดุดันตั้งแต่ยกแรกวินาทีแรกเลยอันนี้เป็นแผนที่วางมาหรือเปล่าครับ
เป็นแผนที่วางมาตั้งแต่แรกแล้วครับเดินเข้าไปเรื่อยๆครับหายจังหวะต่อยครับผมครับโอเคครับก็ประมาณนี้แหละครับ
Yes, that is our plan. The plan is to keep pressing forward, find the opening, find that shot.
That was such an impressive performance that Mr. Chatri Sitiotong has awarded you a bonus of 350,000 baht.
สู้ได้น็อกเอาท์ชนะสวยงามขนาดนี้คุณชาติบอบได้ 350,000 บาทครับ
รู้สึกดีใจมากๆครับผมอยากขอบคุณบอสชาติอยากขอบคุณป๋าสมหมายสกุลเมตตาและทีมงานกลุ่มพลังใหม่ขอบคุณแดงน้าแดงพดมลงรักและแดงเขาทรายและขอบคุณหัวหน้าค่ายหัวชีดพระแก้วและขอบคุณอาจารย์และแฟนหมัดแฟนมวยทุกท่านครับในเวทีนี้ครับขอบครับ
Thank you so much, Khun Shati, for that bonus. I would like to thank my team, Kumbalang Mai, and everybody who's been supporting me and all the fans that's watching me here tonight.
Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner, Sungprab!
Sungprab picking up another knockout. That makes two in a row. Let's take a look again. The right hand.Flying over the top, connecting on Yodnamnuea's jaw, sending him crashing to the mat. Momentarily tangled up in the ropes. Looking so good. The fights have been electric so far tonight, but next week is the biggest one Friday fight event of the year.
This has all the makings of a kickboxing classic. Superborn against his arch enemy, Marek Gregorian. Can he knock out Superborn again?
This is the third one already. He fought two times. One was 2018. It was very, very short. On that day, I knocked him down in the first round. And the second time, it was in 2022. He did a good job.
That wasn't just a win, that was domination.
ชัยชนะที่ชกกับมารัตในไฟล่าสุดผมว่าผมทำทุกอย่างออกมาได้ดีเพอร์เฟกต์สมบูรณ์แบบครับดีแล้วเราก็เอาชนะเขาได้ในทุกรูปแบบเลยคร
ับ I don't gonna talk much this time. I just want to fight. I just want to show on that day that I'm better than him.
แล้วก็ทำหน้าที่ต่างคนต่างทำหน้าที่ได้ดีที่สุดบนเวทีนะครับแล้วแต่ว่าแน่นอนว่าผมต้องชนะแน่นอน
In just 7 days, one Friday fight's biggest card of the year has two title bouts. Superbone and Marek Gregorian battle it out for the interim featherweight kickboxing world championship. And Wanchuchai challenges for the one strawweight kickboxing title against Jonathan DiBella. Global pay-per-view will be available at watch.onefc.com.But up next, we have 126-pound Muay Thai as Songpandin takes on Wanchuchai. Wanchuchai is 11 years older, 2 inches shorter, and has a slight weight advantage as Laos takes on Thailand. Global rules Muay Thai.That's 3 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. 3 knockdowns in a round is a TKO. No throws or grappling will be allowed.
From the blue corner, 1, 2, 3!
Ready to fight.
The debut of Wanchuchai, 74% win rate. He's 27-year-old. He's hailing from Surin, Thailand, fighting out of the Khaosamrit gym in Bangkok, Thailand. One of the many unsung heroes of the Muay Thai scene, especially during COVID, as many of the fighters were forced to stop.Wants to return to his glory days. And one of the reasons for that is being inspired by the arrival of one Lumpinee last year. Sparked the hunger to make
his return. And here we welcome the debut of Wanchuchai.
His story is very interesting. When we spoke to him, he said, when I was younger, I was a technical fighter, Muay Femru. But after moving to the famous Gao Samarit gym, he has worked on his punching and his elbows, and he has developed some real knockout power. Now, he knows that his opponent is very well-rounded, but he thinks that he drops his guard, and that is going to create some important moments for him to land those big punches and elbows. He is going to look for those counterattack moments very carefully here in the ring tonight, Achilles.
Super excited for that debut. Wanchuchai. As he climbs over the ropes, the one Lumpinee ring for the first time here on One Friday Fights.
From the red corner, Songpandin!
Songpandin, the 16-year-old from Laos, has become quite popular at his school after picking up his recent victory in his debut here on One Friday Fights. Got the unanimous decision win over Yot Sing Dam. And this youngster has got that Muay Bu style. So you know he likes to be aggressive. He likes to come forward. He wants to get the finish. He told us he's been working on his speed, Brian. And I'm really excited to see what this young man has in store for us today.
Only 16 years old, but already 40 fights worth of experience under his belt. Unbelievable. When we spoke to him about his opponent and his game plan, he said, I know that my opponent is technical and that he's strong, but I am younger, I am faster, and I'm more powerful. He is really believing in the power of his punches in this fight. He said, I am going to start fast, and I'm going to use my best weapon, which is that right straight. You can see carved into his head there, the largest martial arts organization in the world. One, he is truly a dedicated competitor. I cannot wait for this one, Achilles.
Songpandin from Laos. He told us that no way is this going three rounds. He is predicting a knockout finish in his second outing here on One Friday Fights.
Coming up, we have 3 3-minute rounds of a 126-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Gao Samrit, with a fight record of 70-25 and a 74% win rate. Representing Thailand, Wanchuchai. And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Chalongsuk, we said, with a fight record of 33-7 and an 83% win rate. Representing Laos, Songpandin.
มีน้ำใจนักกีฬานะล้มไม่ซ้ำไม่ทำฟาวนะโชคดี
Every fight is how badly do these fighters want it? How badly do they want the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow? And how badly do they want a ticket to the top of the mountain? The key is to let it all hang out here and dominate and try to get the finish. As these two warriors square off in catchweight Muay Thai, 126 pounds, do not blink. Ladies and gentlemen.
You took the words right out of my mouth, Achilles. Especially, you can see it here. We've got that southpaw orthodox matchup. That means the power weapons, the right straight, the right kick, the left kick, are going to be traded often and traded heavily. There, Wanchuchai with a few big left kicks.
Oh, I like the way that Songpandin landed a right hand as he entered the clinch there. Trying to feel each other's muscle, they're trying to feel each other's power. Those were some sharp, fast combinations on the inside with the hands of Wanchuchai.
Songpandin is going to have to find an answer for that inside leg kick from Wanchuchai. That thing is already landing and already got Songpandin very uncomfortable.
And the timing from Wanchuchai, even at the beginning of this first round, being his debut, he's going to need to settle his nerves. He's looking quite comfortable in there as he starts to negate the distance.
In the clinch here, Wanchuchai looking very strong, using his forearm to push the head of Songpandin back, showing his control and composure. Throws the inside leg kick again.
Oh, that was such a veteran move, Brian. Just a forearm on the side of the chin, just to let the young man know that he's here to bully him. Oh, and a nice elbow for Wanchuchai, catching Songpandin. In for the clinch.
So much competitive experience for the fighter in blue, Wanchuchai, and he is using all of it and really demonstrating his pedigree. Oh, and a beautiful elbow as he angles out.
Wanchuchai starting to look comfortable in his one Friday Fights debut. Songpandin, even though he's 16 years old, he has been here before. He has had success here on One Friday Fights, coming off a victory over Yot Sing Dam. He's hunting his opponent, Wanchuchai, now as he lunged for the left hook there, but was unsuccessful with the contact.
You're absolutely right, Achilles, and that's what he needs to do. Throw a little caution to the wind, make it a dogfight, get inside, not duke it out with the more experienced fighter on the outside.
That is why they call Muay Thai the art of eight limbs. Wanchuchai demonstrating that the mix of weapons is what is necessary to get the advantage.
Nice inside low kick there. Wanchuchai so composed, throwing the elbow, another elbow over the top, catching Songpandin. There's the left hand and the uppercut, that patented Gale Samurit style punching from the fighter in the blue. Songpandin had his best moments when he threw caution to the wind and moved forward. Let's see if he can do it again here in round two, Achilles.
Oh, Brian, these fighters are clashing for a staggering $100,000 contract, an exclusive ticket to the world's largest martial arts organization. As these two clinch up and go to work on the ropes, Songpandin is refusing to get bullied by his older opponent. Wanchuchai is picking his shots very carefully.
Wanchuchai using all of the tricks, putting his lead hand out to control the jab of Songpandin, kicking out the lead leg as he steps in to unbalance his opponent, following with the left straight, and the elbows looking so good, but getting caught against the ropes by the younger fighter.
Songpandin with the relentless pressure, catching Wanchuchai off guard. Maybe just a little bit too relaxed in there. And Songpandin shows his experience at one Lumpinee as he unloads with combinations. And Wanchuchai on the back foot now. And Songpandin is in hunting mode. Head hunting for the knockout of Wanchuchai.
This is exactly where Songpandin wants to be. He's got Wanchuchai hurt. He needs to be careful that he doesn't need a counter elbow or left straight, but not too careful to let
country, Laos. From just across the border. Elbows, left, right and center. The knees relentless right now. The pressure from Songpandin is just accumulating. And Wanchuchai needs to pull something special out of the bag if he is to change the momentum in this fight.
Wanchuchai is still looking hurt. He's guarded up. He's hunched over. Songpandin doing a good job of embarrassing his opponent there. He needs to find an opening to land a clean strike.
Shots landing at will for Songpandin. The knees in the clinch. He's got Wanchuchai in trouble. Overwhelming in the first round.
Songpandin getting creative with the knees here, finding different angles, trying to get it to the chin, then dropping the elbow over the top. This is a skill in and of itself when you've got your opponent hurt. Ooh, the left there from Wanchuchai, being able to finish them off. It's a difficult thing to do. Wanchuchai had the interval to recover. Let's see what he can make happen here in the third round, how much gas he's got left in the tank.
The best athletes in One Friday Fights will eventually earn an invitation to one home of the world's greatest martial artists, but they need to show dominance. One Friday Fights is the road to the top of the mountain in the world's largest martial arts organization. Songpandin is here, and his return, he's had a taste of victory in his debut, and he wants more. And you can see that in the desperate way that he's trying to get a knockout on Wanchuchai.
I like the way Songpandin is not just headhunting, he's mixing in some punches to the body, but still struggling to find that clean shot to finish things off. And Wanchuchai looks like he has regained some composure, and he's ready to get back in there with some lefts and punches and elbows of his own.
That's what you can expect from the Muay Thai fighters that have so much experience. Near 100 fights for Wanchuchai. And you can bet for sure that he's been in similar situations like this before. He's been hurt before. He's had to come back from behind before. But none of those before have been here on One Friday Fight here in the One Lumpinee ring. Songpandin showing his experience as he unloads on Wanchuchai.
Beautiful right hands coming down the pipe from Songpandin. Wanchuchai just tucking his chin and marching forward. They're back in the clinch. Songpandin has already proven that he can be effective with the knees here to both score points and do damage to the body.
Wanchuchai doing everything he can as he lands the spinning back fist to stay in this match. But the heart from the youngster from Laos, Songpandin, relentless with the pressure. He believes he can get the victory. He told us, Brian, that there was no way that this is going three rounds. The youngster has tried his best to get Wanchuchai out of there. But Wanchuchai also has an iron will and an iron grit to survive. That is what we are witnessing here.
Wanchuchai just showing his experience again with a cheeky little takedown, eating up some time, making Songpandin uncomfortable. Now getting him on the ropes, taking away the space that Songpandin needs to throw those punches to get the KO. He He's still unloading to the body, but he needs to find something clean to finish with a knockout. Only 15 seconds left. Big shot from Songpandin as he goes to the body and back on top. But Wanchuchai is back into the final bell. Did so well to recover. But the question is, was it enough? Especially, Brian, after the knockdown from Songpandin. He kept pressuring forward. He kept the will and determination to want to win. Take us through the replay here, Brian.
Let's take another look here. That right hand, 1, 2, 3, 4 from Songpandin, just firing it off like a machine gun down the pipe. Wanchuchai looking for the uppercut. Again, not finding a home. Songpandin there again with the right hand over and over, but Wanchuchai, so cagey, inexperienced, able to survive. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Songpandin!
Songpandin with the decisive victory over Wanchuchai, taking his streak to 2-0 here on One Friday Fights. But coming up next, we have Catchweight 132-pound Muay Thai as Chalongsuk takes on Donking. Chalongsuk is 12 years older, 1 inch shorter, and has a small weight advantage. This one is Thailand versus Thailand. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws or grappling will be allowed.
From the blue corner, Donking!
Started Muay Thai at a young age of 7. Donking is making his debut here on One Friday Fights. This 23-year-old from Ranong has an 83% win rate. He's got that Muay Khao, that Krok Krung style, so that definitely means that he's well-rounded. You can expect a full arsenal of weapons from Donking, whether that be punches, elbows, knees, kicks. Donking has it all.
Donking has that aggressive Muay Khao style, but he is also a very well-rounded fighter. That Muay Khao style means that he's gonna like the knees, he's gonna like the clinch, but he told us that his best weapons are his punches. It's not just his elbows and his knees, but he's got very formidable skills with his hands as well. He knows that his opponent is an elite puncher, especially with his own right hand. But Donking says, I'm younger, I'm gonna have better conditioning like so many Muay Khao knee fighters do, and I am gonna march in there, let my hands go. I can get that KO during those exchanges with a counterattack, either as a punch or an elbow. I can't wait to watch this one, Achilles.
Oh, neither can I, as Donking enters the One Lumpinee ring for the first time.
From the red corner, Chalongsuk!
Highly anticipated debut for Chalongsuk. Another unsung hero. This man has over 200 Muay Thai fights, 83% win rate, 65%.
5 KOs on this man's resume, and here is the reason why. His father was a fighter. His brother was a fighter. His father disciplined him to become a champion. This man lives a clean life. No smoking, no drinking, no party life. For this man, he's got a full gas tank. He loves the forward pressure. He's got that accurate punching power. I am excited for the debut of Chalongsuk.
Achilles, let's just take a moment to highlight that stat again of his 190 wins. 190 wins, 65 of those are knockouts. That is incredible. His right hand is a wrecking ball. We asked him what he thought about his opponent, and he said, I know that he's younger and he's got a little bit of a size advantage, but he cannot take my punching power. Chalongsuk said, I am gonna punch and low kick in combinations. I am coming into this fight with great power and great cardio and great combination work, and I'm gonna break my opponent down. Let's see what he brings here in this matchup, Achilles.
Chalongsuk with the debut on One Friday Fights.
Next, we have 3 3-minute rounds of a 132-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Yotarak Muay Thai, with a fight record of 75-15 and an 83% win rate. Representing Thailand, Donking! And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Jackson Muay Thai Gym, with a fight record of 190-38 and an 83% win rate. Representing Thailand, Chalongsuk!
ทั้งคู่นะชกไม่เต็มที่มีน้ำใจนักกีฬาล้มไม่ซ้ำไม่ทำฟาวออกยืดเต็มที่แบบ just.Ready,
Only the best of the best in the world are invited to ONE Championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. And Chalongsuk and Donking make their debut here on ONE Friday Fights. Chalongsuk, he told us he wants to push the pace. He told us he wants to get the finish and push the pace at the beginning. He is right.
Both fighters demonstrating right away their punching prowess, crushing combinations. That right hand from Chalongsuk narrowly missing. The left hook from Donking digging to the head and to the body. Some great back and forth.
Just a bit of bullying there in the clinch, feeling out process to see who has the upper hand, to see who has the stronger upper body. Chalongsuk. He's ready to throw bombs.
Chalongsuk making nice adjustments with his angles, mixing in uppercuts, keeping the guard high, pulling the chin low. He needs to watch out though, too, for the uppercut from Donking.
Chalongsuk started Muay Thai at a young age of 7. Disciplined by his father. The clean life. That is why he's able to make a return to Muay Thai, especially since the appearance of Wang Lumpinee last year. Brought him back, gave him the motivation to want to come back and be a champion.
Ooh, nice left hands to the body from both fighters. Right now, they are happy to duke it out in the phone booth. Donking clubbing with the right hand on the top of Chalongsuk's guard to get some respect.
Donking, worrying too much about the technique there, just worrying about landing. He was throwing haymakers just now. Chalongsuk forced to engage in the clinch. Donking demands respect.
ground knee fighter style, but he is happy right now to engage with the fist. He said he loves to use the punches to get close and let the elbows go, just like he is. Three elbows zinging onto Chalongsuk's face right along the ropes.
Those were heavy elbows, just relentless from Donking as he's starting to find a rhythm now. Weathered the early storm of Chalongsuk. And the 23-year-old from Ranong, Donking, really started to find his rhythm at the end of round one. Landing heavy shots from Chalongsuk. What's your take on the first round there, Brian?
That was a close one. Let's see some of the action here. The knee there from Donking landing. The right hook, the clubbing right hooks from Donking and the elbows. I think those elbows were some outstanding strikes in the matchup. Chalongsuk landing, a clean turned over left hook just under the ear of Donking. Both of these guys so clean with their hands, not giving an inch, a very close round. I would give just a fraction of a lead to Donking at this point.
One Friday Fights is the global platform in search of the next global superstar. And these two debutantes have got to war in the first round, coming out in the second, looking for that KO as promised. Oh, big shot over the top from Donking as he staggered Chalongsuk. Takes the count from the referee now. And it looks like he's able to continue, Brian.
This could be a very big moment for Donking, but he needs to be careful that he doesn't get too aggressive and create an opening for Chalongsuk to land a shot back.
More big shots from Donking as he's starting to show his crisp combinations, landing flush on the chin of Chalongsuk.
Just glimmers of in the first round. Chalongsuk was keeping his head low and his guard high, and that makes him vulnerable to that uppercut. Donking saw it and took advantage, landing a flush one right on the chin and sending Chalongsuk to the mat. Let's take another look here. That uppercut feeding through the guard, setting it up with the right hook and the jab. A beautiful short shot right on the chin here. You can see Chalongsuk, the chin and the head low, the guard closed. Chalongsuk wanted an uppercut of his own. There, a right hand just behind the ear from Donking. But there is that uppercut again. Such a clean shot, it doesn't take much. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 54 seconds in the second round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Donking!
Donking with the impressive debut here on One Friday Fights. Taking out the super tough opponent, Chalongsuk. There you see the combinations over the top, right on the temple. Donking always had the follow-up strike just clocked and ready. But it was not needed there, as the uppercut landed clean, right through the middle, up the top, completely flooring his opponent, Chalongsuk. Making his first victory here at One Lumpinee, an emphatic one. Ladies and gentlemen, after the break, we have an absolute cracker of a Muay Thai fight coming up as Numpangna takes on Jurayev.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
Being at the top of your game is a lonely pursuit. For over a decade, my team and I have built the one brand into a billion-dollar sports media empire. Throughout my life, I've been a warrior in the ring and in the boardroom. Now, I need a champion who can conquer fears, doubts, and insecurities and go to the next level. Across two of the world's most advanced and modern countries, Singapore and Qatar.
Go, Mikey!
10 candidates must prove their mettle in a fear-ignited gauntlet of physical tasks and business challenges.
We want to keep that curiosity.
It's not like customers would realize.
I don't buy
food. It's a definite no-go.
In this cutthroat world where like business is a constant war.
Ever dare to insult me like this.
That's it. I don't give a
there can be.
I hate bullies and I hate liars.
Only one winner.
We want to find the next superstar. Nobody asked you to be here. You can leave.
I need rising superstars who can break new ground and make history, ready to fight and hungry to win at my side. All fighting for one dream. A $250,000 job offer and the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to work directly with me. Welcome to the world's toughest edition of The Apprentice.
One Friday fight continuing to change the landscape of martial arts.
Welcome back to One Friday Fights here from the legendary Lumpinee Stadium. In just 7 days, One Friday Fights' biggest card of the year has two title bouts. Superbon and Marat Grigorian battle it out for the interim featherweight kickboxing world championship, and Wanchuchai challenges for the one strawweight kickboxing title against Jonathan DiBella. Global pay-per-view will be available at watch.onefc.com. But coming out next, we have Catchweight 140 pounds Muay Thai as Numpangna takes on Shakhriyor Jurayev. Numpangna is 3 years older. The height is equal, with a slight weight advantage going to Numpangna. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws or grappling will be allowed.
From the blue corner, Shakhriyor Jurayev!
Shakhriyor Jurayev from the beautiful lands of Uzbekistan. Coming out here for the third time in One Friday Fights. Back really against the wall on this one. He told us he really wants the victory. He's changed up his training. He's changed up his mentality. He still has that Muay Mat style. So you can be sure that he is still exciting to watch, Brian.
He is very confident coming into this fight. He knows that his southpaw style can really throw his opponents off, and he wants to utilize that. He knows that his opponent, Numpangna, is very effective in the clinch and with his elbows. But Jurayev said, I'm good in the clinch too, and I would be very happy to meet him there and
battle it out. His favorite combinations start with his jab and then flow into the elbows and the knees, and those are great ways to move into that clinching position. So we can be sure that we will see some fighting in the phone booth here from both of these fighters, Achilles.
Oh, super excited for the return. Jurayev. He makes the walk for the third time here. One Friday fights. He told us that he knows his opponent is dangerous in the clinch, but he believes that Numpangna's weak side is his left side. And being a southpaw fighter, he plans to go to work on the left side of the body of Numpangna. If his prediction will come to truth, come to reality, will get that finish. It's the extensive gymnastics background that has given him the strength and agility to progress in his Muay Thai career as Jurayev enters the one Lumpinee ring for the third time.
From the red corner,
Muay Thai Phuket. He has a 72% win rate. Racked up three bonuses already here on One Friday Fights. Needless to say that he has become a fan favorite. And it's because of his Muay Thai style, that move forward, that walk forward, that pressure style, that he is such an exciting fighter. And when we asked him what he thought about the foreign fighters that come to fight in Thailand, he told us that he was impressed by their footwork. But he believes that Thai fighters have stronger weapons.
That is what is so cool about what is happening here at One Friday Fights. You have these different styles, these clashes, and fighters from Thailand are meeting these foreigners, and they're learning, and they're growing, and they're developing, and we're seeing the growth of Muay Thai right before our eyes. He said he knows that his opponent is a good southpaw puncher, but he feels like he's one-dimensional, that he's not bringing a complete Muay Thai skill set. So Numpangna wants to use the kicks. He wants to use his elbows. He wants to use his knees. He loves that clinching range, and he predicts a KO in the second round.
We have 3 3-minute rounds of a 140-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of TC Muay Thai and Shakhriyor Sport Club, with a fight record of 35-3 and a 92% win rate. Representing Uzbekistan, Shakhriyor Jurayev. And introducing opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Eagle Muay Thai, with a fight record of 41-16 and a 72% win rate. Representing Thailand, Numpangna.
Okay, box two. Okay, guys, you both understand the rules. Listen to me at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. If you want to touch gloves now. Good luck. Judge, time. Ready?
Only the best of the best in the world are invited to One Championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. And Jurayev gets right to work with the lightning fast team, putting Numpangna on the canvas early in the first round.
Wow, and catching the kick.
whipping Numpangna again. Jurayev showing a pretty complete Muay Thai skill set right now.
Lightning fast combinations from Jurayev. Bad intentions written all over them. Numpangna is trying to recover from the early onslaught.
Jurayev has that tricky southpaw style, and he's using it very effectively right now. Pushing Numpangna back against the ropes. You can see Numpangna is an orthodox fighter. That means they are going to exchange the power weapons. For Jurayev, that would be his left straight and his left kick. Getting out of the way, countering with the left there beautifully. Numpangna, as the orthodox fighter, who used the right hand, who with the right kick, but Jurayev landing a nice left.
That was a nice left over the top, followed by the right hand. Completely flooring Numpangna. That right hand came out of nowhere, Brian.
We knew that Numpangna was such a good kicker. This is a great game plan from Jurayev to catch the kicks and counter. He got
to finish in that first round, but there, the early team, beautiful technique from Jurayev from Uzbekistan.
Catching the kick, landing the right, sending Numpangna to the mat. A great game plan and beautifully executed here, that right hook, left straight, the counter elbow. Great tactics and execution here from Jurayev, the tricky southpaw tonight.
These fighters are fighting for a $100,000 contract and an invitation to the biggest stage in the world, which can lead to millions of dollars in one, the highest pinnacle on the planet. And Jurayev is putting on a performance of his life so far, with a very tough opponent in front of him. And Numpangna, as he feels revived, and takes the elbow from Jurayev. And that is it. The solid elbow from Jurayev, putting Numpangna to sleep.
That was unbelievable. We saw in the first round, at the end, he used that counter. A little step back, avoids the right straight. Numpangna counters with the left elbow. Here, he uses it to finish the fight. Incredible technique demonstrated here from the fighter from Uzbekistan. Just stunning to watch. Let's see that again. The lean back and the left elbow landing. Numpangna staying up for a second, but his legs melting away, falling to the mat. The lean back, the elbow, picture perfect. What a beautiful way to counter the strike. The power strike from Numpangna. The right hand misses. The left elbow from Jurayev lands. And that is it. What a finish. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 23 seconds in the second round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Shakhriyor Jurayev!
Jurayev putting himself right back in the mix with an incredible victory. Let's go to Achilles for the post-fight interview.
Congratulations, Jurayev, on an amazing performance. Tell us now how you are feeling.
ครับผมวันนี้เราอยู่กับผู้ชนะของเรานะครับชาคริยอมนะครับเราอยากจะถามครับว่าการชนะในวันนี้นะครับผมเขารู้สึกยังไงบ้างครับ
Спасибо, Ассаламу алейкум, Алхамдулиллах. Today makes me very, very happy because my father deserve. Thank you, attention. Thank you, my gym. Thank you, my sponsor. Thank you for attention, my Mr. Chatre. Thank you. Thank you, one championship. I like you.
วันนี้นะครับเขาอยากจะบอกว่าเขาอยากจะรู้สึกดีใจมากๆครับและอยากจะขอขอบคุณโดยเฉพาะคุณพ่อของเขานะครับที่มาอยู่กับเขาในคืนนี้ขอขอบคุณทุกคนที่สนับสนุนเขาขอบคุณค่ายของเขาครับ
That was again an amazing performance. Do you have any words for all your fans back home in Uzbekistan?
นอกจากนี้นะครับเราอยากจะถามเขาว่าเขามีอะไรอยากจะบอกถึงแฟนๆของเขาที่รอชมอยู่ในอุซเบกิสถานไหมครับ
Avalambur Ota-onamga kattakon rahmat. Mana o'zim otam Sherli Jurayev kattakon shu odamga kattakon rahmat. Mening shu jaradara chiqargan shungacha shu otamga kattakon minnatdorchilik bildiraman. O'zbekiston hammaga yutuqlar bilan tabriklayman. Thank you everybody.
Thank you very much. Thanks to my father and my coach, and I'm very proud to be his son. Thank you for everything. He gave me everything, and I'm here just because of my father today.
เขาอยากจะขอขอบคุณทุกๆคนนะครับที่ให้แรงสนับสนุนเขามาโดยตลอดนะครับโดยเฉพาะคุณพ่อของเขานะครับผมที่เขามองว่าเป็นไอดอลและมอบทุกอย่างให้กับเขาครับ
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your winner, Shakhriyor Jurayev. Shakhriyor Jurayev. Put a smile on my face with that masterful performance. So technical, the lean back to the elbow. But it wasn't just that finish, it was everything. His game plan, the execution. But it cannot be denied. That is one of the best counters I have seen in this ring. So clean, so precise. But, ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. We have our main event coming up. 140-pound Muay Thai as Panrit takes on Alexey Balyko.
One Friday fight continuing to change the landscape of Muay Thai and martial arts. Everybody off their feet inside this Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. Oh my goodness! With the one shot, one kill! What a highlight reel, bang on the chin!
And it's over, and the fans love it!
Youngest one world champion, Smila Sundell.
Well, like a hurricane, she overwhelmed her opponent. It's a dazzling performance by the strawweight Muay Thai world champion, Smila Sundell. And this one is over.
Familiar face to Muay Thai fans around the world, the pretty killer, Iman Barlow.
She really is something special.
A real world-class talent. You can see why she's a multi-time world champion, but she wants that one goal.
Jackie Boonton!
She's a multi-time American Muay Thai champion.
Oh, there's the left hook I spoke about.
Yeah, Jackie Boonton is a serious high-level striker.
Huge combination!
Wow, what a statement made!
The Italian, Martin Micheletto, a four-time world champ in kickboxing. Heavy shots, heavy artillery!
Here comes Ekaterina Bondarieva, hooks the punches! What a dominant performance from Ekaterina, big overhand right!
Welcome back to One Friday Fights here at the iconic Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, finally the main event has arrived. Catchweight 140 pounds Muay Thai as Panrit takes on Alexey Balyko. Balyko is 3 years older, 1 inch taller, and gives up a slight weight advantage to Panrit. This one is Thailand versus Russia. We're going global rules Muay Thai. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point bus system will be in play. Three knockdowns in a round equals a technical knockout. No throws, no grappling allowed. With both fighters coming off wins with bonuses, this main event is guaranteed fireworks.
ผมเป็นหลานพี่ซูเปอร์บอลครับแอนดี้บอลเป็นไอดอลแล้วก็ประสบความสำเร็จมาเยอะแยะมากมายครับผมก็อยากเดินตามรอยพี่ครับ
Balyko! Big shot over the top!
Да, получилось выиграть нокаутом мой крайний бой. Я этому очень был рад. Очень этому был рад и надеюсь продолжить свою серию побед нокаутами. Надеюсь, получится его закончить досрочно.
What a changer! Panrit gets it done! My goodness!
Alexey, he has beaten a Thai man before, but he hasn't met me yet. In his heart, he wants to knock out. He wants to take the bonus to build a house for his father and mother.
Победа для меня будет очень важна. Это опять очередной шаг наверх на путь к чемпионству.
ผมตั้งเป้าไว้ว่าปีนี้ผมต้องได้เซ็นสัญญาวันแชมเปี้ยนชิพชัยชนะครั้งนี้ผมก็เป็นแรงบันดาลใจให้ผมสู้จนถึงฝันจริงๆครับ
Russia, they grapple for fun. When he's bored of that, he
went on to play ice hockey. And you know, if he played ice hockey, you can be sure that he likes a good scrap, Brian.
He has such a dynamic, interesting style to watch. He's really at the forefront of this hybrid technique where he's mixing Western boxing and kickboxing and Muay Thai and really taking the best of all those worlds and putting them together. But what he does absolutely the best is that beautiful footwork into those incredible punches, Achilles.
From the red corner,
results here on One Friday Fights, but recently coming off the success of the knockout of a Gong Kai in the third round, that has set him on a new path, a new mindset. He once thought that he was invincible, but he knew coming into One Lumpinee, One Friday Fights, he had to find the best version of himself, and he believes that he has found that, Brian.
Achilles, Panrit looked so good in his last fight against Gonglai, really demonstrating his patience, his accuracy, the use of all of the weapons. It was such an impressive victory. We asked him what he thought about this fight. He really gave tons of kudos to his opponent. He knows that he's fought big names. He knows that he's fast, has great footwork, and is a great puncher. But he said he saw some holes in his defense. And in order to beat him, he was going to need to train his durability, some of those special Muay Thai weapons like the flying knee and the high kick, and he was going to have to wade in and engage in the danger zone a little bit, but make use of those elbows and those knees as well. This is going to be an incredible fight, Achilles.
Oh, I can't wait for this one, Brian. As Panrit told us, he wants to take steps towards earning that life changing $100,000 contract. He wants to follow in the footsteps of his idol and hero, Superbon, who we will see in a week's time from now. But for now, Panrit enters the One Lumpinee ring. Something to marvel. As these warriors prepare for battle, pay respect to their teachers, to their family, sealing off the four corners, the mental preparation, the physical preparation, something that these warriors practice and live by on a daily basis. Why cruel? It's a way of showing that respect to the sport that we all love, to the sport that has become the most exciting combat sport right now, which is Muay Thai, the art of eight limbs. Fists, the elbows, the knees, the shins, all of these weapons accumulate to the beautiful art of Muay Thai. As the final prayer is said, the monk on is removed. We get to business.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of one Friday Fights 57. Three 3-minute rounds of a 140-pound Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Tiger Muay Thai, with a fight record of 22-9 and a 71% win rate. Representing Russia, Alexey Balyko. And introducing the opponent, out of the red corner, training at a Superbond training camp with a fight record of 70-29 and a 71% win rate. Representing Thailand, Panrit.
Okay, guys, you both understand the rules. Listen to me at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. If you want to touch gloves now. Judge, time. Ready? Chop.
One Friday Fights is the global platform in search of the next global superstar. Alexey Balyko and Panrit are on the path to that, as Alexey Balyko is looking for his hat trick, his third win in a row here on One Friday Fights.
That is right, Achilles, that you can see right off the bat the stylistic differences here. Balyko with a little bit wider stance, very light on his feet. The lead hand moving around, trying to distract and set up opportunities for the jab and the cross. Panrit steady with his stance, hands up. He is going to want to engage at that closer range with the elbows and the knees.
Motivated and dedicated more than ever, trying to achieve his dreams. Oh, and a big shot! A short left hand, just clipping the chin of Balyko. As Panrit lands that lightning fast hook to start the first round, getting the count on Balyko.
Beautiful, sharp, short left hook there. You are 100% correct, Achilles. Beautiful counter left hook. here. Balyko catching the kick, looking for the counter, not finding it, but there is that short, sharp counter left hook. Panrit throwing some low kicks that were really effective. Let's see what happens to the pace and the techniques here in the second round.
Only the best of the best in the world are invited to ONE Championship, the world's largest stage of martial arts, representing the pinnacle of fighting. And these two top-class athletes are going to war in this main event of ONE Friday Fights.
Balyko doing a good job of changing levels with his combination, going through the jab high, the cross low, and the left hook high. Coming back with a high kick, but Balyko just driving forward and sending him to the mat.
Balyko really catching the timing of the kicks of Panrit. Another flying knee attempt, and the ragdoll from Balyko sending Panrit to the canvas. These two are in a very high pace battle right now, ladies and gentlemen. Do not blink. That was a heavy shot to the body from Balyko, and the return fire to the leg. In this main event so far.
You can say that again, Achilles. Do not blink. So much speed and precision from both of these fighters. You can really sense the urgency in Balyko here, wanting to get a down, wanting to make it even, knowing that Panrit is up on him right now at this point.
Sizing up each other. Again, the kick. Nice 1-2 combination. Balyko starts to put the pressure. Good boxing work, as we've seen many times on the fighters for Thailand Muay Thai. Crisp boxing.
Balyko has that great in and out footwork, and that sets up opportunities for counters. But Panrit is staying patient and not really biting on the hook, not really moving in. So it's taking away that counter ability from Balyko, forcing him to drive in.
I don't know if that's the calf muscle of Balyko, or if that's just a big welt on the left side of the calf. But the leg kicks from Panrit are sneaking in there. One too many more than Balyko might like. And there it is again, Brian, lightning fast, that one.
Beautiful calf kick there. We know how many Japanese fighters have had to train at Super Bowl training camp. They love that technique. Conrad has probably been sparring with them and picking up some skills to add to the toolkit. So effective. And look, Balyko has switched his stance. He is not liking that low kick one bit, Achilles.
Conrad able to connect with that time after time. The body shot straight from Balyko, trying to put pressure on Panrit. The Russian fighter showing his grit and iron will to win. But he keeps getting touched with the leg kick and the attacks from Panrit. You were in the corner of Balyko right now, Brian. What would you be saying?
He needs to make something big happen here, and I have a feeling he is going to come out crazily in the third round. Here is some of the action, some of their exchanges. Balyko pulling back from the calf kick there, coming back with a counter to the body, looking pretty sharp. But the fact of the matter is, Panrit got that sneaky down in the first round, and that means he is up. Balyko is going to have to make something big happen here in the third, and I think that means that he is going to come out very fast. You can see he's already in the center of the ring, ready to make this thing happen.
Oh, these fighters are fighting for an invitation to the big leagues on the world's largest stage of martial arts. Warriors have not disappointed so far. The fans are in suspense to see who the winner will be out of this match. Again, the heavy body kick from Panrit landing flush on the body of Balyko.
Balyko catching the kick, coming back with punches. Hard to tell if they landed or not, but Panrit doing the good job of keeping it standing, throwing the front kick, throwing the low kick. We need to keep attacking those legs to shut down the footwork of the surgeon, fighter from Russia, Balyko. Blood is pouring out of the left shin of Balyko. And he does not even feel a thing. He is still pushing forward, still looking for the finish. Experience. What a great level by Thai of Panrit. He is able to still avoid the big shots of Alexey Balyko. He knows this point in the fight is very important. He has the lead and he needs to hold on to it. There is no room for error. Error on Panrit's part right here. Balyko, on the other hand, needs to throw some caution to the wind and get in there and make something big happen. Balyko knows that he's behind on the scorecards. He knows that this bout is running away from him second by second. That is why he is pushing non-stop despite all the pain that he has taken from the big shots from Panrit. Balyko is still searching for that knockout. And if Panrit isn't careful, he might get clipped. There is absolutely zero room for error. Both these guys are so good, and the little gloves do not lie. Balyko has Panrit's back against the ropes. He did until that throw to where he wants to be.
Just ragdolling Panrit down to the ground. Balyko has had success in the clinch, catching the kicks of Panrit. But the damage, the significant striking, definitely coming from the corner of Panrit.
That's right, Balyko needs to use some feints. He needs to get the attention somewhere, find a hole for a big overhand right or a flying knee, something big, because there is only 20 seconds left in this bout. And Panrit is doing a great job of eating up that time.
Finish Alexey Balyko off. Right to the final bell. Such a high level technical Muay Thai battle between two veterans of the sport. Back and forth action in this main event here on One Friday Fights. Alexey Balyko taking the early knockdown, round one. Take us through the replay, Brian.
Let's see some of this action again. The low kick there being caught, the sweep from Balyko, catching the kick again, touching with the left hook, but Panrit staying standing, showing his balance. Balyko lunging in with the 1-2. But the guard up from Panrit. Let's go to Nara for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Panrit!
With the victory, taking his streak to 2-0. Against a strong opponent in Alexey Balyko. He put in the work and he got the result that he wanted and emerges the victor. But in the Monster Energy fight of the night, goes to Morten Ong and Tomoya Maruyama. And woo, did these two go to war? The strike, flush on the chin, the straight right hand. We saw the opening. Boom, that was all she wrote. Clock back, the snap, flush, the accuracy was on point. an impressive start for Maruyama, but the force of Mor Ten Oom was just too much, earning him the Monster Energy Fight of the Night. Ladies and gentlemen, in just 7 days, one Friday fight's biggest card of the year has two title bouts, Superbot versus Marat Grigorian, battle it out in the interim featherweight kickboxing world championship, and Prajan Chai challenges for the one strawweight kickboxing title against Jonathan DiBella. Global pay-per-view will be available at watch.onefc.com. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been an amazing night of fights. I am Achilles Rally. That was the legend, Brian McGrath. See you next week for more Friday Fights.